the Busch Series. Tonight, Martin Truex Jr. and Kyle Busch look to get back on track at the Lowe's Motor Speedway. To North Carolina. I'm Bill Weber. It is a cool, crisp, and should be a very competitive evening. 16 drivers in this race tonight will also compete tomorrow night in the Nextel Cup event that will be held right here at the Lowe's Motor Speedway. In the championship standings, Martin Truex Jr. leads second place Kyle Busch by 149 points. Tonight, Truex, driving car 8, starts 9th, and he's with Dave Burns.
Martin Truex finished 14th here in May. That started a string of 14 races in which this championship leader did not see victory lane. Martin, are you looking to start something a little better here at Charlotte tonight?
I hope so. This track's been a struggle for us. This is the only place I feel like we've got not a good chance of running good. So I feel like my car's pretty good this weekend. We've worked real hard on it, tested here, and hopefully we can get the best Pro Shops car top 10. That'd be a good night for us.
Look for that black number 8 starting inside row 5. To Matt Yoakum.
Dave, Kyle Busch is hoping for a night tonight like the day he had here in May when he earned 69 more points than Martin Truex and went home with the winner's trophy. Harder or easier to chisel away at that lead tonight with so many cup guys in the race?
You can look at it on both sides of it. You know, it's definitely going to be harder because of those cup guys and the experience that they have. But, also it could be on the other side because we've run well here and we've been able to do well here. And the 8 car really hasn't proven themselves, but obviously qualifying good, they might have a better car here this time around. So I'm looking forward to it. Hopefully that we can put it in the same spot we were here in the spring, and maybe they can put it in the same spot they were too. So we'll just have to see at the end.
If he puts it in that same spot, victory lane would be the first time since 1996 in Mark Martin that a driver swept both races, Busch Series here at Lowe's, in the same season. To Marty Snyder.
Matt, just a few weeks ago in the Busch Series race at California, Casey Mears started first and finished second that night. Tonight, Casey Mears starts first, so can you do one position to better tonight?
I think we can do it. You know, we just got to, you know, do everything right, not make mistakes. Got a real fast race car. You know, we didn't get too many laps on it. You know, we ran like 10-lap runs in practice. Hopefully it just stays consistent all night long. The track's really cold right now. It's really cold outside, so I think there's going to be a lot of grip. I think it's going to be exciting.
Casey looking for Busch Series win number 1. Dave, back to you.
Kevin Harvick makes his 18th NASCAR Busch Series start of 2004. This former series champion finished 3rd at this track here in May. Kevin, can you be as good tonight or even better?
Well, I hope so. This race at Chevrolet has been really good since we unloaded it, and so we hadn't raced under these conditions before, so we'll just have to wait and see and make the right adjustments to our car. But we've run good all year, and we just need to get a couple more wins in that victory column, so that's what we're shooting for.
Very cool conditions here tonight. If Kevin wins, it'll be the first of any kind for him here at the Lowe's Motor Speedway. Bill?
Dave, along with Casey and Kevin, Matt Kenseth, Jimmy Johnson, Bobby Labonte, Sterling Marlin, Michael Waltrip, all in the starting field. Now, let's take you trackside and join this evening's pre-race ceremonies at the Lowe's Motor Speedway.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, will you please rise and remove your hats as the Air Force ROTC Detachment 592 at University of North Carolina, Charlotte, present our nation's colors. At this time, will you please welcome Kenny Crosswhite from Motor Racing Outreach to deliver tonight's invocation.
Father, we do thank you for this evening that you've given us, certainly an evening to rejoice in. We thank you that you've made yourself known and available to us, and we invite your presence here tonight in Charlotte. May each team and all involved be surrounded with your grace. Father, we thank you for the freedoms that you give us in this country and those that serve to protect them. May we never take them for granted. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, will you please remain standing and join Crystal Craig in the singing of our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming.
The drama is on TNT, Saturday night at 8.
Our talented drivers scattered throughout the field. And starting 28th, there's our pal Wally Dallenbach. He's with Marty.
I don't know quite how to take that, Bill. Wally finished 10th last week, and if you're going to win this bet with BP, you got to get going if you want him to wash your car. You got to finish in the top five, Wally.
I know, Marty. I've been trying. I'm trying. We had a good shot at the top five last week, and fortunately we missed Tony, but we did some damage to the nose. So the green-white checker's a little bit tough, but I think we got a pretty good car this weekend, and believe me, there's nothing more that I want to see is Benny washing my car.
You know Alan's back, right?
And I know Alan's back, and I'm sure he's on his butt because he's wounded, and who's carrying him this week? Who's up there, Kurt Busch?
Yeah, Kurt.
As long as we got somebody carrying him, we're going to need all the help we can get.
All right, Wally and Mr. Clean, as Bill said, start 28th tonight.
And obviously the tone for the evening has been set. Tomorrow night, 500 miles for the stars of the Nextel Cup Series. You'll see it live on NBC beginning at 7 o'clock Eastern Time. Tonight, 300 miles for the stars of the Busch Series. And now it's my pleasure to send it upstairs to the guys that will call the race. Of course, Benny Parsons and a broadcast colleague whose career has been on ice for the last couple of weeks but has been boning up on all the facts and figures. Welcome back to Alan Bestwick.
You spent all day thinking of that, didn't you?
And last night.
Yeah. All right. Thanks, Bill. Believe me, it's great to be here. All right, things to look for in tonight's 300-mile race. Tricky turn four. BP, it's eating up some cars here this weekend.
Sure has. Busch Series, Cup Series, doesn't really matter. I think the problems start in the middle of three and four. The cars go down in the corner. Unless they hit that bump or the middle of the corner perfectly as they come off the corner, they're going to make some contact with the wall. Our points leader, Nextel Cup, Kurt Busch, in happy hour, comes off and smacks the wall. Some concern about whether the car was too damaged. He might have to go to a backup. They were able to repair the car. He's not in a backup, but that shows just how tough turn four is.
Kurt will join Benny and I for the call of the race momentarily, as you heard Marty discuss with Wally. Anything Kurt's little brother Kyle can do to try and make something happen in this championship tonight?
I don't think so. I think that Truex is running so well that Kyle Busch has to depend on him having some kind of trouble, to make any gain on the 8 car.
Weather a little chilly for the folks in the grandstand, but it's great for the drivers in the cars, and the action gets started just moments from now. Let's go trackside.
And now, race fans, please welcome back this evening's Grand Marshals for the most famous words in motorsports.
Tonight, a chance to win before friends and family. You're watching NASCAR on TNT.
Here's Stacker 2.
Motor Speedway Charlotte. It's the SpongeBob SquarePants Movie 300. On a
very chilly night. Cars rolling onto the racetrack to begin their parade in pace laps. We told you the Nextel Cup Championship leader was going to jump into Wally's seat up here tonight. Kurt Busch, how are you?
Not too bad. That's a little flat on the right side, I guess.
We have showed the fans your career.
Tell me you haven't.
Several times. Coming off turn four, what happened?
We were on a long run just trying to get a good feel for the car. Looked underneath Kyle. Next thing I knew, boom, the car had been loose the whole run. And then that lap, it just got tight on me. So we were trying different things, and that didn't help the process. So now we've got to go, and the guys have to work all night straightening out that right side of the car. But no real big setback.
Good. Cars is okay. No structural damage.
No, not too bad. Just had to string the rear end a little bit. It was off, and they're going to make the analysis on what they have to do. And then the front end, just a tie rod. So we'll straighten things out. Nothing too bad.
You'll be in good shape.
I think so.
Let's talk about tonight's race. How about it? Our Castrol GTX starting grid. Casey Mears, Robbie Gordon on the front row. Two of six drivers racing tonight that will also race tomorrow night. Got a bunch.
Row three, Blake Feast, 00, his second NASCAR Busch Series race ever. He's in some really fast company.
There's championship leader Martin Truex Jr. back in row number five.
And you know what? Jimmy Johnson hasn't run a NASCAR Busch Series race in 2.5 years. He's in tonight's race. Jimmy Johnson, Benny Parsons, you got me? I just talked to him a minute ago. Let's try. Jimmy Johnson, Benny Parsons, you got me?
VP.
So it took a cartoon to get you back to the Busch Series, huh?
Yeah, it did. Looking forward to having some fun tonight with this SpongeBob car. My couple guys are down there helping out with me. We're going to have some fun tonight. And the Busch guys put together a great race car for us. Hopefully we can go out and have some fun tonight. Looking forward to good things, buddy.
Is the car good enough to win?
I believe so. You know, it's a different format having a qualifier car and then leave it alone. So I don't have any experience with it. Of course I'm going to say it's capable of winning, though.
Well, give it your best shot. Go to it, man.
Appreciate it.
Jimmy Johnson going to start in 20th position, row number 10 tonight. Keep an eye on him throughout the night. Lap and a half from the start, and some final stories from pit road before the green. Matt, got to be some news on Greg Biffle, huh?
Greg Biffle qualified third, but Alan, during that qualifying run, he experienced a problem. The engine sputtered, the fuel pressure gauge bounced back and forth. So this afternoon, crew chief Brad Parrott swapped out the fuel pump, did a lot of investigation, but they didn't find anything out of the ordinary. So now they're starting this race at the back with their fingers crossed. But even though the weekend got off on the wrong foot, they're still confident they can score their season 6 victory. To Marty Snyder.
Matt, one man that may have a leg up on the competition is Joe Nemechek. He starts sixth, the winner last week at Kansas. Talked to him just before he got in the car. He said, this car is every bit as good as it was last week. Even though it's not the same car, I have the same feeling inside the race car. They did not have a final practice in the Busch Series. Joe said, yesterday in practice, this car was terrific. Dave?
Marty, a shadow of doubt was cast on Ashton Lewis' future when his dad decided to close the team shop at the end of this year. But the phone's been ringing for Ashton. I talked to him earlier today, and he said he's got one good option that he was pursuing from before, and he got another good option this week. And Ashton told me both cars, either one he chose, if he gets the opportunity, would be very, very competitive. Alan, did you get that all?
You guys worked all afternoon on that,
yes,
didn't you?
Yes, and last night.
Yeah. We have a theme going here. I expect the abuse.
And I talked about, Jimmy Johnson talked about, he hasn't done this before. The car impounded after qualifying, not able to run anymore. The NASCAR Busch Series tried something last night that they do occasionally, but never at a big racetrack. They practiced for 2 hours, they qualified the cars, impounded them, and no one able to get back in the car again after that.
This is something you normally would see like at a short track across America, like on a Saturday night, they qualify the cars. Even in what I used to do, the Southwest Series, they would impound the cars after qualifying, but heck, we're only on a half mile, 3/8 of a mile normally. I think they did this earlier in a couple of short track venues for Busch. They did it at Daytona, but this is a mile and a half, very treacherous racetrack, and it's very different between qualifying and race conditions.
And the Busch Series officials have told these teams that they may do this as many as 30 times next year.
Yeah, there's something they're trying out, BB, and I wouldn't be surprised if you saw this as the future of what we do in cup racing, to try to eliminate some of the time that the crew spends out at the racetrack, getting the cars through tech, and just trying to to give us limited track time out on the track. Try to condense it a little bit.
Pit road speed, 45 miles per hour. And, Kurt, this is also a pit road that's pretty doggone tough to get onto.
It is. Your tires are worn out. You're sliding around. And 3 and 4 is bumpy. You never know when it's going to stick and when it's not. Then you got to lower up from that speed.
46, NASCAR Busch Series race here at Lowe's Motor Speedway, about to get underway. Been running here since the series was formed in 1982. Casey Mears, Robbie Gordon on the front row. The championship contenders, Martin Truex starts 9th. Kyle Busch starts 18th. Kyle won here the last time the series was on this racetrack back in May. Good crowd on a cool night. And a green flag is in the air. We're underway.
Car 66th on the outside, going by Blake Feast. As I said, this double zero car, his second race ever. He's got to be nervous with all these great drivers all around him.
They definitely had a good qualifying lap. It's a matter of now getting into a pace and seeing how Blake is able to get that car underneath him and just ride.
And he can't go too slow because, trust me, these guys will run over him.
Oh, they'll lead him up, that's for sure.
Casey Mears leads lap one. Here's the race from third on back. Feast in that double zero, the red and white car. Benny, these first couple laps after the cars being impounded, qualifying in very different weather conditions yesterday than the start of this race right now. Got to be a little nerve-wracking.
There's a bunch of unknowns. Each of the teams wanted to get the best baseline they could in race trim, and what they'll do is they'll throw on tape and then go to qualifying right at the last part of practice, and you don't know what you're going to get when you tape it up. So they really worked on race trim, and you're going to see some cars moving forward and some cars moving backward.
There's your championship leader, Martin Truex, in the 8. He is running in 7th place, Dave.
And I asked Martin Truex that very question. What do you think of the impounding based on how you have to start your car? He said, the only thing I don't like about it is exactly what you said, Kurt. I don't know what I've got. So far for Truex, he's been able to pass cars and stay on the bottom line. It looks like he likes it.
Blake is doing an awesome job in that high groove. Harvick's been taking his time getting around him. You want to take your time at the beginning of a run when you have all these unknowns.
Close right behind him.
They're stacking up back there.
Black car there, Casey Kane in the 38, almost made it 3 wide under Mike Bliss in the 20.
Oh, and Bliss, I thought he was going to go up the racetrack and make contact with the car on the outside. The red and white car 20 is Mike Bliss. Oh, trouble! Jason Keller. Oh, I thought he had it saved, but he has made easy. Oh, he hits the wall with the left rear and left front.
Caution flags out. Oh, Ashton Lewis going around in turn 4. That was probably somebody didn't get the message. The yellow was out and slow down quick enough.
Just spun out on our own there, Charlie.
Or maybe not.
Yeah, maybe not. Spotter says, all by ourselves. Talking about Ashton Lewis, the 46 car.
Pretty good damage there to Keller's machine.
There it is.
This team announced this week they need a sponsor for next year.
And Tim working on the car. Let's see if we can see what might have happened. Just all by himself. Jason Keller. Around he goes. So he will not be a fan of. But, you know, he had damage to that left front before he spun.
Did he? I didn't get to see that. It's lap 4 of a run, and your tires are going from the good, sticky goodness to what your car is going to start to drive like. And he was on the outside.
He might have made contact with Mike McLaughlin in the 25, and there was a damage on the left front.
Definitely.
More damage to the left front.
That didn't
last hit was big. Another look at it, right side of the screen.
There's the damage on the left front.
Mm-hmm.
I got it. Oh, maybe I don't.
Almost
maybe
got it.
Maybe I don't. Oh, darn.
Somebody unleashed a can of bees in the car. He was swatting. Poor Jason.
So a bad break for Jason Keller, and the first caution is out here in Charlotte.
Who knows how to say most valuable player? Yes.
El jugador más valioso.
Very good. El jugador más valioso. What about 3 championships? Yes.
Tres campeonatos.
Excelente. Tres campeonatos. What about most dominant center ever? Yes.
Yao Ming.
Yao Ming?
Bill Russell?
Go to the principal's office.
Nothing is more dramatic than the truth.
Coming to the restart here at Lowe's Motor Speedway Charlotte, SpongeBob SquarePants movie 300 on TNT. Here was the second of the two spins.
Dave Blaine in the Goose Pump Car. This is Jimmy Johnson on board with him as the 46 car, Ashton Lewis, just loses control.
Came around with no major damage, did make a pit stop, is back in 36th place as Lewis, after starting in 10th.
And Kurt, why do these guys spin the tires at this racetrack on restarts? We see it all the time.
This racetrack's very slick, and the springs that we're running in the back of these cars are so stiff, they don't provide for much forward bite, but it gives you good attitude through the corner when you're at speed. But, we notice it all the time here in the cup cars as well. We have more horsepower than the horse cars.
Casey Mears, the leader. Robbie Gordon is second. Jamie McMurray, third. Joe Nemechek, fourth. And Kevin Harvick is fifth. Races for third. Nemechek looking on McMurray.
That's Nemechek, the red and white, 87. McMurray in 66.
He's in the 88 this week. He must have given the 87 number to Austin Reed for a run.
Yep. That's exactly it. They were already committed to run this race with the Hendrick Development Program. Joe had such a great weekend last weekend, he wanted to keep that momentum up.
May as well bring it out again.
There's Truex trying to get by in the 8, trying to get by McMurray in 66. A battle for the 5th position.
Not quite. It's one of the great things about this racetrack is you can find some place on the track to better suit your car's handling. You saw McMurray able to move up there and hold off Truex, who was running the bottom.
That's one unique thing about this track. You'll always see the cars bottom out a little bit in 1 and 2 because the banking over there is steeper, and you get through there so much quicker. 3 and 4, it's very rough. It has less banking, so you just see the cars always bounce around and dance through 3 and 4. But if your car's money, you're going to be fast in 3 and 4 on the king. Caught that cushion the wrong way, as you would say in the dirt track.
Even that 38 car, and he loves the high side, the high groove. Here, Michael Waltrip, one that we always talk about it, but they're up there faster than anyone.
Yeah, might not work out for him in that corner, though. Mike Bliss diving underneath right behind him. Championship contender Kyle Busch in the 5.
A.K.A. Patrick. Looking pretty good.
It's a character from the movie that's on his hood, right?
Right on the bottom, yeah. Patrick and got the SpongeBob right behind him, so the two are teaming up.
We're on board with SpongeBob. Jimmy Johnson, the driver.
Notice here through 1 and 2, you see the sparks flying. Sometimes you get such a good bite through the middle of 1 and 2, you stand on the gas way early, and it just gives you a nice launch out of 2, and your car will drag a little bit. Truck arm mounts, or even the side skirts.
By the way, that was Jason Keller just coming off the pit lane with the leaders went steaming by there in the picture a minute ago. A couple of pit stops for Keller. How about Kyle Busch, Dave?
As we're talking about those restarts and spinning tires, the only real conversation under caution that Kyle had with crew chief Lance McGrew was about cold tires, and Lance just reminded him, make sure there's heat in them before you get started.
Basie Kane, we saw him just a moment ago on the high side trying to make some passes, but he has fallen back in the clutches of Kyle Busch in 5. And meanwhile, here we see the Mike Bliss on the inside of Blake Feast.
A little shuffling going on in that group, BP.
Yeah, Feast, the 00 car, is really doing a good job. He realizes that he's in some very fast race cars, fast company, and he's trying to run as fast as he can and yet not get himself in trouble.
Feast, man.
During that caution, Booty Barker was telling Blake, he says, look, you are doing exactly what we need to do tonight. Just get yourself in line. Let's log some laps. He did tell Booty the car was a little free at the beginning of that first run.
Fifth NASCAR Busch Series race this season for Blake Feast, a 22-year-old out of Saybrook, Illinois. Another one of those drivers in the Hendrick Development Program.
It's the second race in the 00, isn't
it?
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah. I wish we would be.
Okay, gotcha.
Kyle Busch still not able to work his way around Blake Feast, but he'll keep pushing in there for 10th position. While up front, Casey Mears has led every lap so far. 15 of 200 are complete. You're watching NASCAR on TNT. Sports live at Lowe's Motor Speedway Charlotte with the SpongeBob SquarePants Movie 300. Playing the lead role at the moment, Casey Mears, starring front and center. Oh, he's a Californian. He's close to Hollywood, Bakersfield, right?
Yep.
Leading now a new second place runner, Joe Nemechek is a second and a half behind him. Robbie Gordon now third, Matt Kenseth fourth. Kevin Harvick has slipped back to fifth place. Speaking of slipping back, Jamie McMurray at 66.
Let's see.
Started fourth, BP.
Yeah, he's all the way back to the ninth position. And in jeopardy of losing that to Kyle Busch in five.
There's the SpongeBob Patrick duo. Just kind of riding along with one another, working their way up towards the front. It's interesting to see that the cars that have qualified up front, like Mears, is doing awesome. He's laying down good lap times. He's running competitive. But then you've got these guys that qualify 18th and 19th, Kyle and Jimmy, respectively. They're working their way towards the front.
So I can't ask you that. It's really difficult for Jimmy to jump into one of these cars that he hasn't been in a couple of years and just go on a one-off like that.
I talked to him at one of our tests. We tested so much lately, I couldn't tell you which track it was, but he was excited about the opportunity to run a Busch car. They have shorter wheelbase, and he almost felt like they had more downforce. Then I talked to Joe Nemechek, who's done well with both cars recently, and Nemechek says, no, Busch cars still have less downforce. But Johnson said he was all gassed up about it, and he's looking for a good run.
More on this, Matt?
Looking for a good run, but that was one of the biggest adjustments that he had to make. It's been a couple of years since he was in a Busch car, and like you mentioned, it does take a little bit of an adjustment going from the Cup car to the Busch car.
He came to this speedway a couple of weeks ago in the 48 car, Jimmy Johnson, and tested. Spent a couple of days here in this car, getting it acclimated to it so he wouldn't look too bad tonight.
Oh, definitely. You got to get your feet wet and science out the springs and the bars and the way you have to approach this racetrack. But his teammate, Kyle Busch, has an awesome race car. He won the last race here. He's working his way towards the front.
Just took eighth place away from Kevin Harvick, did Kyle in the five? Last time Jimmy Johnson was in a NASCAR Busch Series car, Homestead, November 2001. Now, Greg Biffle in that 60, BP, had to go to the back to give up his third starting spot, then made a pit stop under that caution flag, and he's charging up through the field.
Trying to get through the field, but these guys now are caught up behind the 87 of Boston Reed, and it has been a real deal trying to get through this traffic. Matt, what about the 60? Is it okay now?
BP, he had to pit due to contact with another car. The left front corner of the valance, he pushed that in on the tire, had a tire rub, came in, pulled that out. As he was leaving, he said, this thing just will not run, but he is making some headway going up through the path.
Where was it we heard Greg Biffle complaining on the radio in the car that won the race?
California.
Yeah. So if it won't run, then he's probably in pretty good shape.
Yep.
He'll be fine. He's running good lap times right now. He's a guy that wants to lead every lap and to make sure that he does well. And he does well in every race that he jumps into. It's just this race, you have a little problem at the beginning. He wants to upset you, but he's a sharp character. He'll go to the front.
He restarted 40th at lap 8, and he is up to 26th now. Here's your leader, Casey Mears.
Mears is doing it. Look, I mean, just consistent lap times. He had the fastest lap time again. And it's one of those situations where you don't know what kind of car you're going to have. They impounded cars after qualifying. He laid down a blistering lap. Some of the teams might have expected him to drop off, but Mears has got a great setup underneath that car.
And pulling away from second place, Joe Nemechek, Dave.
And Kurt, I asked crew chief Brian Patty about that very thing, and he said, you know, in the only practice session we got, we started out with a qualifying type of setup and clicked off the fastest lap of anyone in the session. Then we went right to race setup and stayed that way the entire time and then just taped it up for qualifying. So it's not a surprise we're doing well in the race, and I, too, expected that they might have gone a little toward the qualifying side, but they didn't.
Brian Patty's a smart individual. It was tough to see him break up from the Joe Nemechek combination. He's got so much talent as a crew chief that can just find the right niche on what you have to do with the new program. He's definitely got the 41 motoring.
Casey Mears got his best ever NASCAR Busch Series finish last time he drove this car. He's out front tonight here in Charlotte.
Over 147 mile an hour average, and we approach the one quarter mark of the event. Let's take you through the field, set up how the front runners are doing well or not doing so well. We start on pit road with Dave Burns.
Casey Mears doing very well, Alan. He's really only had one scare so far tonight. On that first caution, he said, you know what, someone must have laid something down in the corners because I almost spun out too, but he didn't, and he still leads. Marty?
Dave, Joe Nemechek's a man trying to track down Casey Mears, and he's doing a pretty good job of it. Car started
free. It has gotten better, coming in nicely, Joe says. As Alan says, this wasn't on the schedule. Monday, he added it. And the good thing, Mom Martha is here tonight if Joe can pull out the win. Matt Kenseth bottomed out really hard on lap two. Thought he might have broken a front sway bar. Then he came on lap 10. Setup is money in the battle for the lead.
Casey Mears looked like he had to hesitate when he caught Justin Labonte.
As soon as he ran up behind the 44 car, he struggled.
Oh,
Nemechek, around he goes.
Second place car is crashed and the caution is out.
Man, that thing came around quick on him.
Do you remember the race here in May when Joe came tearing up through the field and then spun out trying to get second place? Mm-hmm. Remember when he was trying to come back and catch Kyle?
He may have been over in one and two in the same spot, wasn't
he? Boys, we're all done, man. Sorry about that.
So much for momentum.
He was rolling, too. I've noticed the last few lap times he was the quickest car on the track.
But it seemed like when Casey Mears, the 41, ran up behind the 44, just that dirty air or something, all of a sudden he started slowing down dramatically. Here we see the 88 Nemechek underneath 41. And Kirby, you lose that air, that off the rear spoiler, it's tough underneath somebody.
It is. He had his nose about 12 inches further forward than the 41. And when your nose is just a little bit further forward these days, it just seems to plant it right into the ground. Turn one is probably where you're going to be the loosest. Well, three, you're also a bit loose on entry here.
So you plant the nose, which makes the back end come around and get loose.
It's just when two cars are side by side, it just goes directly to the car that's 12 inches in front. And he had all the air on his nose. And it just seemed like the tail got light on him with the 41, pinching him down a little bit.
You know, I was just checking my notes. Joe Nemechek was leading in May when he spun out with 17 laps to go.
Alan's a historian. He's got us under check.
It's not working out for Joe here at this racetrack in the NASCAR Busch Series this year, is it?
No, he's going to the garage. As he told his crew, we're done.
So second caution is out. Pit road is closed because they have some debris to pick up on the exit where Nemechek spun. So it's going to be another second before we see some pit stops.
All right, Wally, our boy Wally, is not going forward. He's back in 32nd. Hey, Wally, BP, you got me?
Yes, I do, BP.
Wally, you're not going forward. What's up?
Push. I'm pushing pretty bad right now. I mean, the steering wheel feels light in my hands going through the corner, so I'm going to try to get this thing loosened up or get some grip in the front anyway.
Someone told me you got some damage to the left rear. How'd that happen?
I got a pretty good restart on, I think it's the 87 car. Got up on the outside of him on the restart. Guess what? He didn't know I was there.
I see. So you've told the crew and they're going to make some changes on the pit stop, huh?
We're going to make some changes on the pit stop and see if we get some grip in this thing. I think we're close, but, you know, with no happy hour and everything, the way the rules are now, we kind of have to throw the dice, and I think we're going to be okay.
Hey, by the way, Kurt Busch doing a heck of a job filling in for you.
Does he need me to replace him tomorrow?
That's a negative. Turn four wasn't too rough.
This will be open this time by.
All right, so Wally and the rest of the front runners will probably head to pit road here, lap 38. I would think they'll all be looking for a set of tires.
Definitely. This place chews them up. It's almost as bad as Rockingham and Darlington. It's part of that southeast.
About to change tires three times under the caution flag tonight, and here they come to the commitment line.
That's another rule that the NASCAR Busch Series officials are talking about changing next year, limiting the amount of tires. All right, here we go. Pit stops. Marty.
Well, I was getting ready to tell you about Matt Kenseth's car. He said the setup is money right now. A little bit loose, half turn in the left rear. Also a half pound on the right rear tire for Matt. Very happy with the 17 car. Matty.
Marty, on the bottom of your screen, Robbie Gordon couldn't believe how well the car stuck when he drove it in too deep earlier in the race. But now he says it's up on top of the racetrack. Track bar and wedge adjustment to try to tighten the race car up, Dave.
Leader Casey Mears radioed his crew. Wow, that was close. The crew agreed. Too close. Just a slight air pressure adjustment for Casey to fix it tight from the center off condition. He leaves and will win the race off pit road.
And look at Truex in the A car. He may win that.
It just depends on where the pit road camera is. I think the benefit's going to go to the 40. Whoa, the A-car got him. Check that out.
So, big roar from the crowd. as Martin Truex Jr. takes the lead. Of course, the Earnhardt connection pretty strong here in Charlotte. A happy pit crew got the job done.
Dry rinse Oliver soap. Pure filter technology. Mr. Clean Auto Dry Car Wash. Spot-free shine with no need to dry. Guaranteed.
Say this is the corner right here. If I get down to the center, the car gets a little loose on me. I think some wedge will help it out, okay?
All right.
By the way, thanks, Mandy.
Anything to help the team, David.
Handle your curves like customer-turned Trim Spa X32 supermodel Mandy Thrawn. Get Trim Spa and make your ultimate comeback.
I take a couple of pounds out of the right front.
What?
Trim Spa, baby.
It's a showdown in Charlotte. The chase has reached the midway point.
97 can drive in so deep.
But if you don't have Nextel Track Pass on NASCAR.com, you only know the half of it.
I'm going to have to go to this last race, and I'm going to have to win it.
Get insider access and get the whole story from here to Homestead.
Well, NASCAR.com don't get no better, right?
Join the chase for the NASCAR Nextel Cup with Nextel Track Pass Chase Edition. And get exclusive content on AOL from NASCAR.com.
As any military man worth his salt will tell you, the choice of artillery will vary from operation to operation. Consider a daylight maneuver with a strong civilian presence. Here you'll find the manual calls for a lighter ordnance. Mission accomplished. Sometimes the light way is the right way to live the high life.
Dear Stacker 2, I began taking Stacker 2 products on March 15th, 2003. I weighed 311 pounds. I wanted to join the military and help defend this great nation, but I couldn't because of my weight. With the help of Stacker 2 Ephedra Free, I lost a total of 121 pounds. Last summer, I enlisted with the United States Naval Reserve, and I would like to say thank you. With the help of Stacker 2, I am living my dream. Sincerely, Troy Ushover.
Stacker 2 Ephedra Free helps burn fat, controls cravings, and boosts your energy. Real people, real results.
Monday nights on TNT. 2 hours, two cases, two great dramas. Monday nights belong to TNT. Watch Law & Order at 10, followed by Without a Trace at 11. Every Monday night on TNT.
Get ready to go back racing here at Charlotte. How about the Aaron's pit summary? Say that Martin Truex Jr.'s crew did a terrific job with their pit stop.
Yeah, because he was not in the top three coming in, but guess what? He's the leader now.
Yeah, came in sixth, came out first. You see Casey Mears. Actually, he's going to end up second. Mike Wallace stayed on the racetrack for most of the caution, then just pulled off and pitted here on this last lap of yellow. So Mike had been the leader when that came up. Matty?
And Joe Nemechek just walked out of his trailer. So, Joe, let's take a look at the replay. What do you think happened?
It's just racing. You know, he got really, really close there. He got really, really close to the back end. I didn't get to see it there, but now I got under him. You know, we caught all the lap traffic there, and it was time to make a pass. Just going in one, he got right down on that right rear, and it just sucked my car around. It's just typical racing. Just unfortunate. Doesn't need to happen this early.
So Joe Nemechek, first car out of this race, crashed racing for the lead with Casey Mears, as you saw just a second ago. So Martin Truex is the new leader. Mears is second. Matt Kenseth third off pit road. Robbie Gordon fourth. Mike Bliss fifth.
Man, is that back stretch rough, huh?
Looks like a tabletop you'd seen at off-road track.
Man, those cars are dancing.
Good race back there.
That is David Stremme in the 32, who lost a lap on pit road in the middle of that. McMurray, 66, yellow car, really having some troubles here.
We see Jimmy Johnson in the SpongeBob car moving forward. You got to keep up with them, folks, because in a couple laps, it's going to be important.
good. Kyle was able to make that turn in the middle of 3 and 4 and look underneath McMurray coming out of 4. Couple good cars.
Jamie McMurray started 4th. He slipped back to the end of the top 10 in the opening run of the race. Gained a couple of spots back on the pit stop. Now he's not able to hold that ground. He's back to 7th. Here comes Kyle Busch in the 5, looking for that position. Right behind them, Dave Blaney. How about the job Blaney's doing in that 82 car? Somebody just lost a tear off.
Fantastic.
Yeah, Blaney was actually filling in the 99 Cup car in happy hour today. Getting Carl Edwards' car dialed in for him, just running some laps, making sure things are clearanced, and they ended up having a rear-end problem. But he did a great job just getting that 99 car in, and then boom, here he is in a Busch car racing away.
Oh, 3 wide. Harvick, Blaney, McMurray.
Oh, Harvick wisely in that 21 car backed up just a little bit.
He probably shouldn't have done that in the first place.
Alan talked about a tear-off. These guys run some strips on the windshield. Got trouble off turn 4. Boston Reed, the 87 car, goes around and around. And hang her down there, Boston.
Where she stops at the start-finish line without hitting anything.
And Derek Cope has spun the 49 car as well. I don't think he hit anything.
Here's Derek, who is back on track after being in the garage
who
area.
Hit me from behind, Hermie.
Wanting to tally up.
All right, there we see the 87 car. He's going to get a little bump from 10 feet away in the red 12. And around he goes. He gets in the grass, and, well, there's no stopping it there.
There's 2 full spins.
I go for 3. Almost.
Just a little bit of help from behind. He might not have been full throttle, and then we see Cope have his problem. Somebody got in the back of him.
That was Hermie.
Cope had seen the traffic up ahead.
Hermie Sadler in the 0-2 ran the back of Derek Cope. We're talking about those tear-offs on the windshields. The crews can rip off a film, and it cleans off the windshield. At Talladega, several cars lost all their tear-offs.
At that drafting speed, you feel that.
Under caution here at Charlotte.
Join the chase for the Nextel Cup and get insider access with Nextel Track Pass Chase Edition. And get even more exclusive content on AOL and from NASCAR.com.
Are the brake pads and shoes really guaranteed for as long as I own my car?
Yes.
What if I need additional work?
We'll explain it all before we do anything.
In a written estimate?
Yes.
Could you read that last answer back for me, please?
Yes.
Visit Midas now and get brake pads or shoes for just $39.95 plus installation. We'll provide a written estimate for installation and fully explain any additional work needed. For mechanics known for their work and their word,
trust the Midas touch.
Abandon their kitchens for Ponderosa. There they enjoy our Ponderosa spread with new buffet items daily, all for just $7.99. And they can add a sizzling sirloin combo, flame grilled steak with your choice of grilled shrimp, chicken Monterey, or fried shrimp. The buffet plus the combo, all just $9.99. Dinner time may never be the same. Ponderosa, welcome to our spread.
That was a good one. Honey, did you get it?
I got it!
What would you do on your own private island? Check your mail for the Capital One No Hassle Island Giveaway. You could instantly win your own island for one of hundreds of island getaways.
What's in your wallet?
John Kerry and liberals in Congress have a health care plan. It includes the IRS, Treasury Department, and several massive new government agencies. Your doctor? In here somewhere, but not in charge. This $1.5 trillion government program puts bureaucrats, not your doctor, in charge of your healthcare decisions. One more reason we can't risk the liberals in Congress and John Kerry.
I'm George W. Bush, and I approve this message.
Pace car out in front of the field, still cleaning up the third caution flag out tonight here at Lowe's Motor Speedway Charlotte. Keeping an eye on Jimmy Johnson in the number 48 Lowe's SpongeBob car at lap 48. Take note of what place Jimmy Johnson was in. It was sixth, by the way. Go to Lowe'sRacing.com. You can register to win the Ultimate Racing Prize Package, which includes a VIP trip to next year's Coca-Cola 600. Remember, sixth place. Mark Truex Jr. is the leader. This the reason for the caution flag. Boston Reed and then Derek Cope with separate but related spins off of turn four.
Here you go, boys. Here you go. Get the scent. Got the scent? Go find him, boys.
Introducing the award-winning Outlander Max. It can handle extra tough conditions and one or two riders. Thanks to its exclusive convertible seat rack system.
I guess someone's got a long walk back.
Guess so.
Don't get stuck with anything less. Bombardier ATV. Follow no one. Now with 3 years of free extended coverage.
Michael Waltrip?
Yes.
That's cool.
Okay, what are we waiting for? Waiting on you.
I'm waiting on you.
I'm waiting on you.
You are in for a treat. You're gonna be right down in front. Morning. You can be able to see the whites of Michael Waltrip's eyes. How about that? Bobby, come on.
Best Western, the official hotel of NASCAR. Race to bestwesternracing.com right now for up to 50% off on your next stay.
The drama of the NBA returns to TNT next Friday. Shaq and the Miami Heat take on the Atlanta Hawks, followed by Kobe and the Lakers against the LA Clippers. NBA doubleheader beginning on TNT next Friday, 8 p.m. Eastern Time.
I want to see Miami play the Lakers.
That's coming.
Yeah.
Gotta wait.
Did you see the highlights on the sports this morning of Yao Ming's visit to China?
That's huge.
Played an exhibition game in China. Oh, my gosh, what a reception. Well, still getting some bits and pieces cleaned up over in turn two after this last caution, but we're getting ready to go back to green. Martin Truex Jr., the leader. Casey Mears, second. Robbie Gordon, third. Mike Bliss, fourth. Matt Kenseth is fifth.
There's Dave Blaney. That's running eighth position. Good run for him.
Wally has moved up to 23rd.
All right, they made some adjustments and they worked.
He said they were close.
Yeah.
Pace car's off. Watch for those spinning tires we talked about on restarts. Didn't see any big wigglers there.
Yeah, not too bad. It's pretty quiet.
Truex in the eight. NASCAR Busch Series Championship leader. His title rival, Kyle Busch, runs in seventh place right now. This is a track where Martin Truex has not enjoyed success. His best finish, 14th here. And Kyle on the move.
Jimmy Johnson going as well in the 48 car.
Getting by Kenseth. Kenseth's car, they said last time it was just starting to come in before that yellow, and that was lap 38 or so. So he has probably a loose race car to start off a run, and it gets better and better, as Kenseth always does.
So Kyle Busch to sixth place. Matt Kenseth back to seventh. Dave Blaney challenging him there. Blaney in the white 82 on the inside lane.
Looks like the 82 and 21 are good on the short runs, as well as the SpongeBob Patrick duo. But we'll see. It's starting to transition now. The cars that qualify well, and then here's some of the cars from the back are moving forward.
Yeah, talk about moving forward from the back. Michael Waltrip started 34th, Matt. He's up just outside the top 10.
They made a shock change right near the end of practice, and Michael really didn't get a chance to really feel it out. That's why he felt like he had such a poor qualifying effort. But the team's concerned now. Look at the right front headlight cover area. There's some cosmetic damage. They asked Michael, how is the race car doing? He says, the car feels great. They said, we can't believe it's not pushing because you've got some damage there. The team is trying to get a really good look at it to see exactly how big of a piece of aluminum they're going to have to cut to try to fix that on their next stop.
Yeah, it looked like
looked like a pretty significant hole.
Yeah, it's a little tough to see because of the dark paint job on the car in that part, but it is definitely wrinkled back. Huh?
Mm-hmm. That's Sterling Marlin in the one car. There we go, trying to get by Jamie McMurray in 66, battle for the lead. Here comes the 41 car. Casey Mears on the outside of Martin Truex.
He's drove it into three and it's stuck right through the center, and here comes Gordon following suit. That was close. It didn't look like it was clear low, but he made it in front of the Truex car.
So for Truex, he's collected 5 bonus points for leading laps. Good for him.
That's key.
And for Casey Mears, he led the first 39 laps of the race before they made the pit stops, and he got beaten off pit road by Truex's crew. So obviously a very fast race car still.
Hey, Dave, something wrong with the 8, or he just kind of running around the racetrack right now?
He did talk to his crew during that last caution, Benny, and he told him, I'm having trouble getting down into turn 3. I can get good on the throttle. I'm good when I hit the gas, but I just can't get into 3. And notice they passed him coming off 4 and down the straightaway.
I got you. Yeah, when he backed off to go in 3, they drove up on the outside of him.
So Truex back to third spot. Here's Jimmy Johnson working on Mike Bliss. Bliss in the 20. In fourth place, driving for Joe Gibbs. And driving for his future. Mike not really knowing where he's going to be racing next year. Talk with him this afternoon. How about Jimmy Johnson, Matt?
Says the car is great, Alan. In fact, tonight is a huge family affair for the Johnson family. Brother Jesse doing a special radio broadcast just for kids. In fact, he even had to go to Jimmy's PR representative to set up an interview for the pre-race segment. Just like any other broadcaster, he's high atop the stands calling tonight's race and watching his brother run in the top 5.
Just another textbook move by Jimmy Johnson. He's able to keep the car right on the white line through 3 and 4, and just time to throttle right where he was able to pull up underneath that 20 car. And we'll see if Kyle's able to follow suit. Looked like he was running a bit higher, but if he can put it right on that white line and wait for the 20 to slide up, that's what he learned from last time, I guess.
Didn't move up that time, did he?
Nope.
And open that door. How about the 5? What's he saying, Kyle Busch?
Kurt's younger brother's car was a little bit tight on that last run. Last time they pitted, it was about a 3 out of 10 tight, according to Kyle. They made a track bar adjustment to fix that, and Kyle's moved forward. Marty?
Mike Bliss, the man in front of him in the 5th position, is running pretty well, a little bit loose. He said it feels like it's abusing the right rear tire, worried about it leaning on the right rear tire coming off of the corners. They made a wet adjustment on the last stop. Mike said it's loose, but it's fast.
So Mike Bliss hanging in 5th place. Let's drop farther back and pick up a side-by-side race. This is for, what, about 23rd place. Jimmy Spencer and Blake Fease.
Oh, Casey Kane.
Wow.
Heavy contact in the 38 car. That wasn't a clip. That was a full-blown haircut there, wasn't it?
He got his wig
right
smoked.
The front is a broken power rod or something for sure right now.
In other words, he can't steer the thing.
Try to work his way down into the garage area. That was a tough hit.
So caution flag is out, and Casey Kane with a pretty good pop. He had a crash here in the May race as well that ended his day when he was running pretty competitively.
You see the right front tire is not working at all.
What we have of the crash? Top of the screen, there he is.
We see the big black mark back between the middle of 1 and 2. There's a brake rotor flying around on the racetrack, and all of a sudden,
oh boy,
something broke on the right front.
Yeah, that tire went down, or something broke on the right front.
Now watch, you're going to see a piece of brake rotor about there going down the racetrack. Remember last week, Mark Martin flattened 2 right side tires on a piece of brake rotor.
I've been in that same boat here at Charlotte as well. There's sometimes when you hit the wall that it the impact is so severe that it knocks those brake rotors out. I've run one over and gotten a flat tire.
Pit road is closed. Casey dropping bits and pieces of debris down the pit lane. So let's take a break. Caution flag out. Casey Kane with a hard crash here in Charlotte.
They call it the most extraordinary way to travel on land. No matter where you go, in a Featherlite luxury coach. Unparalleled amenities and conveniences accompany you. A others call the Featherlite Coach the world's most extraordinary way to, well, party. Now is the time to own a Featherlite or ask us about renting this incredible luxury vehicle. Enjoy.
Brian Newman drives just like you. He warms up the car. Fights his way through traffic. And hurries home at the end of the day. That's why he depends on Mobile One for advanced wear protection. Nothing outperforms Mobile One, the official motor oil of NASCAR, specially formulated for today's trucks and SUVs.
Dry rinse Oliver soap. Pure filter technology. The new Mr. Clean Auto Dry Car Wash. Spot free shine with no need to dry. Guaranteed.
The SpongeBob SquarePants Movie 300. Rose Motor Speedway Charlotte under caution for a fourth time. No takers among the leaders on pit road, doesn't look like. As the pit road is open, but all the front runners stay out on the track. So we'll take a break. Lots of bits and pieces to pick up down the back straightaway after Casey Kane crashed. Casey Mears is the race leader.
The only network dedicated to drama.
It's under arrest.
TNT. More drama than NBC.
More drama than ABC.
More drama than CBS.
More drama
than Fox.
Get your hands up! Let me see them!
With NYPD Blue, ER, Judging Amy, and every weeknight at 7.
Were you lying then, or are you lying now?
Law and Order.
It's okay to cry.
Great drama.
Papa.
All day long. The Drama Network. TNT. We know drama.
It doesn't matter if you're Jimmy Johnson or Bill Johnson. You've always got a team ready to help. Lowe's, improving home improvement.
Say this is a corner right here. If I get down to the center, the car gets a little loose on me, I think some wedge will help it out, okay?
All right.
By the way, thanks, Mandy.
Anything to help the team, David.
Handle your curves like customer-turned Trim Spa X32 supermodel Mandy Thrawn. Get Trim Spa and make your ultimate comeback.
I take a couple of pounds out of the right front.
What?
Trim Spa, baby.
Officer, I'm chasing after a UFO. Big old silver disc. It was unbelievable. It was going like at least 1,000 miles per hour. Blind in my face. I had to go after it. Oh, my gosh. No, don't write me a ticket.
Tired of all the bull? Get YJ Stinger Extreme Energy Drink now in four cosmic flavors, including the new Chronic Cola. Drinks now available with zero carbs and sugar-free.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, what a beautiful morning.
For those who never quit, the battery that never quits, Energizer. Keep going.
It's our latest construction. Reese's White Chocolate. Creamy white chocolate. Smooth Reese's Peanut Butter. Get lost in a Reese's White Chocolate.
The SpongeBob SquarePants Movie 300 from Lowe's Motor Speedway on TNT is brought to you by SpongeBob SquarePants the Movie. By Mr. Clean Auto Dry Car Wash, never dry your car again. By Trim Spa X32, your dream body diet pill, Trim Spa, the envy. And by Energizer, keep going.
All right.
We are going.
Green, green, green.
Robbie Gordon does not want that 8 car to get by on the restart and leaves the outside open for Jimmy Johnson in 48.
He'll jump all over that opportunity.
Takes a spot away.
Select the line on the old Hollywood squares. I'll take the center square block.
And outside right to clear.
Yeah. So Jimmy Johnson to third, Martin Truex back to fourth, ahead of Mike Bliss, who holds down the fifth place. While we watch the action on the track, we check into the garage with Matt.
Paul Andrews and the guys in the 38 team are working on the car. Casey, what happened?
I really don't know. We had a better car. We made that pit stop, had a better car. We're going back to the front somewhat, and just something broke. I don't know if it was a tire or an arm or something, but something snapped, and there's nothing I could do at that point. So I don't know. It's nice to have soft walls, LaJoy seats, bell helmets, and that kind of stuff happens.
It's good to have the entire pack when you get into a situation like that, guys.
Yes, sir. Safety equipment is your friend. Casey Mears, the race leader.
Have you tested out these soft walls anywhere, Kurt?
Oh, come on, BP. I've rubbed them a few times here and there, and I think I was the first candidate.
Oh, that's right. Brickyard, when you backed in at turn three.
Yeah, I was doing a pretty good mile an hour there. So I tested it real well for him. But I've been able to bounce off walls here and there and still survive, so I'm pretty fortunate. It's not really a good thing to go and test off one, though.
That was the question you were looking for, huh? Well, here's some candidates.
Wally's in there.
Last Saturday in Kansas, everything that happened on the racetrack happened right in front of Wally, and he missed them all.
That's Aaron Fike in 43, Blake Feast in double zero, and Wally behind these guys.
Looking for a way through. This is back for about 21st, 22nd, 23rd.
Well, he's going to try the high side. Meanwhile, Jimmy Johnson. SpongeBob going in the second position, trying to, takes it.
Working his way towards the front, slowly but steadily. We knew we'd see that 48 car towards the front.
Yeah, let's talk about Jimmy Johnson here for just a second. In the Nextel Cup side of things, he had a bad week last week in Kansas, needed to get some momentum back in their corner. How much will tonight help regain their momentum for tomorrow? Does it apply?
Charlotte's on the schedule, and that'll definitely build the momentum for that 48 team. He's a guy that I understand Bristol in a certain way. He knows this racetrack in a certain way. He gets pumped up for it. It's Lowe's Motor Speedway. And every time when you come to race here, you just gauge yourself off the 48 car. That's what the other 42 teams do in the garage area because he is that stout.
That's pretty strong. Pretty good compliment for the 48 and Jimmy Johnson, Chad Knaus, and entire crew.
They do a great job at this track.
Oh, that was close. Listen, the red and white 20 almost got the back of Truex in the 8 as he tried to make that pass up in 3 and 4.
And here comes the other championship contender creeping up on Truex's bumper, Kyle Busch in the 5. How about Truex, Dave?
Martin had a long discussion with crew chief Bono during that last caution period, talking about what they would do to the car on the next stop. And everything they talked about, Martin kept adding, don't hurt my exit. He really likes the way this car is coming off the corner. It's getting in and through the middle. That's been hurting him tonight.
AC Delco Championship standings. The points as they run. Check the gap between Truex and Kyle Busch. It was 149 to start the night. Truex has led a lap. Kyle has not. And they're separated by 3 positions on the racetrack.
That's how different this track is. In October, the night race, Kyle was the car to beat when we were here in May, and he just pulled away from the field. Tonight, he's been a car that's been riding around 6th, 8th place. Right now he's in 7th, just trying to get a feel for what he can make as far as changes to his car. Relay that to Lance McGrew, and hopefully they'll be a little better at the end to gain some points.
Still watching Mike Bliss, stalk Mark Truex Jr., and Robbie Gordon. Robbie has kind of gotten things turned around with his NASCAR Busch Series team. They went through some real struggles this summer.
Well, I mean, it started off so well. Early part of the year, this 55 car was a threat almost every race. But you're right, in the summer, there was a moment.
Yeah, a little wiggle off of 4. You can change your line so many different ways at this place. And you're right, BP, he started off strong. They didn't even know they were going to run through the middle stages of our season. They put together some great runs, was able to win at Richmond. But just a matter of racing race after race, getting the crew to gel with one another, and you can come up to the racetracks and feel more confident.
Right. Bobby with his best ever NASCAR Busch Series start here tonight when he was on the outside of the front row. Marty, how about Mike Bliss?
This car's a little bit tight right now. Alan, the last time he was following the Bass Pro Shops car, it was last week at Kansas and making friends with his corporate teammate Tony Stewart, or not making friends with Tony Stewart. Bliss got a pretty fast car right now, but like you talked about, Alan, this is a man without a ride for next year. He's auditioning right now. He has been told he'll not be back in this 20 car next year, and a caution on the track.
Boston Reed has found some trouble.
He has found the outside retaining wall.
It's interesting. It's in turn two in the same spot that Kane had some problems.
Mm-hmm. Another one of the Hendrick Development drivers, 21-year-old from Logansport, Indiana, in his second NASCAR Busch Series race, and this one isn't going to work out. Also ran the Richmond race back
like
in September.
No, you don't have any brakes because you've knocked a rotor off the right front when you make contact with the outside retaining wall.
So don't step in front of the car, crew. Yikes.
I guess the rear brakes is what stopped it. There's not a lot of rear brake, but enough to bring the car to a halt anyway. I got a little bit of a fire under there.
Took off to the wall.
Or probably was going down. Just get a tire on it so we can roll it back to the garage.
Gary Putnam, the crew chief. Marty?
Yeah, Alan Boston had told the guys that the car was extremely tight, just would not turn in the corners, and he found the limit of where it wouldn't go. He said it just took off to the wall. As you heard him on the radio, they are going to the garage right now.
Okay, leaders last pitted at lap 38. VP, Kurt, going to be lap 77. Pit road's going to be open. Takers?
I guess they got to, but got an awfully long ways to go on one more set of tires.
Some days it's better to be a driver than a crew chief.
Excellent point.
Yes.
This is where I'd say, Fenning, the car is handling this way. It's good. It's coming to, maybe, or it's already burned. It's good off the tires. And you just have to relay as much information as you can to the crew chief, and he'll diagnose and make the decision from there.
And what we're talking about right now, NASCAR restricts the amount of tires these teams can change on a caution flag. This race, it's three sets under the caution flag, and here they're all coming to change that second set of tires. Now, they've got to run 120 laps remaining in the race, changing the tires one more time. Marty, coming to you.
VP Mike Bliss, bottom of your screen, hits pit road running fourth. They're a little too tight. They want to go halfway back on the adjustment they made last time, which is a wet adjustment that they undo this time. Matt?
Marty, Jimmy Johnson says the car is solid on entry, but when he tries to get into throttle, it's tight on late exit. They made a track bar adjustment. Dave?
No changes for the leader, Casey Mears, although they did take tear-offs off the windshield to give him a better view. Crew around to the left side now. They came out second on the last round of pit stops. We'll see if they can win the race. They won't, because others, it looks like, took less than four tires.
Hey, what, Robbie Gordon had a great pit stop. What if he changed two or four?
Follow up when we come back. Caution is out. Number five in the SpongeBob SquarePants Movie 300.
TraxLock, selectable two- or four-wheel drive. GPS Escape, navigation system. Automatic or ESP push-button shifting. You need advanced ATV technology from Honda, because in the real world, trails don't clear themselves. Get the best on earth. Now with financing as low as 6.9% fixed APR.
They've sold over 27 million albums.
That's what it's all about.
And now from Brooks and Dunn, the Greatest Hits Collection 2, featuring their current single, That's What It's All About.
This is a life I couldn't live without.
17 great songs from country music's most successful duo ever.
In there in time, when the reasons all begin to rhyme.
Kix Brooks and Lonnie Dunn, Brooks and Dunn's Greatest Hits Collection 2. Available October 19th at Target.
It's me, your Crock-Pot slow cooker. Thanks to Banquet's new Crock-Pot Classics, I'm easier than ever to use. Banquet Crock-Pot Classics come complete with big chunks of tender meat, fresh sliced veggies, and perfectly seasoned sauces. Just pour in Banquet's delicious ingredients, add some water, it's that easy. By the end of the day, you've slow cooked a delicious meal, like chicken and redskin potatoes or hearty beef stew. Home cooked meals have never been easier. So get crockin' and try Banquet's Crock-Pot Classics, new in your grocer's freezer.
I started racing when I was 10.
Back then, it was me, the track, and my 5-horsepower go-kart. Now, it's 720 horsepower, 200 miles an hour, at a track that doesn't forgive. I've got the best team a driver could ever hope for. The pros at Hendrick Motorsports and the quality CarQuest auto parts they depend on. And at my age, that's impressive company.
CarQuest Auto Parts, the professional choice.
Why turn off the engine when you can just turn off the blade? The right tool for every project. Innovations for the good life. Craftsman at Sears. It projects a perfectly straight laser beam, so you can end up with a perfectly straight cut. The right tool for every project. Innovations for the good life. Craftsman at Sears.
He posted the trophy earlier. That's the one he's trying to get his hands on. Our guest, Kurt Busch, tonight. It's been a pretty good season so far, and six races to go.
Not bad. Those are good times, and we always forget the good times because you're so involved with what you have to do to make your team competitive each and every week. And tonight, we had a little brush with the wall, and everybody working and jumping in and then getting back out on the track in happy hour, making laps, knowing the car was okay. It turned out to be an okay day, and we felt like we were having good times.
Would you rather be, right now you have a, what, 39-point lead in the NASCAR Nextel Cup? Would you rather be leading or chasing?
Well, we're in the catbird seat. It's better to be leading, yeah, as many points as we can grab each week. But there's so many cars that are in this chase. It's not just one or two guys. I mean, we can have a bad race, and we'll be all the way back to eighth. That's the stress. That's what we're having to deal with each and every one of these races. It's just the competition value around you. But if you work on just your program, that's the least amount of worry.
Well, we'll find out how you make out in the six to go race tomorrow night here at Charlotte, NBC, 7 o'clock Eastern time. And if I grab my lineup somewhere in front of me, I'll remember where you're starting, but I think it's like 21st.
21st. That's about our average. You know, we're not too hot on qualifying, but here we go on the restart.
Robbie Gordon, now the leader. Four tires on his pit stops.
Well, that's a 31 Singler crew, and they are very, very fast when it comes to changing tires, doing the pit stop on these cars.
Jimmy Johnson pressuring for the lead. Mike Bliss third. Martin Truex fourth. Matt.
Great stop by the 31 guys, but they wanted me to point out that it was indeed a four-tire change. It's just how fast it was. But also, there is one guy, Larry Hunter, the gas man. He's from actually the AOL 30 team. So all RCR guys here for Robbie Gordon.
Okay, so they got one guy that's not with the 31. Okay.
That's part of that deal that Robbie made with Richard. Richard provides the engines and the pit crew support, and Robbie does the rest. Here's a gaggle.
Michael Waltrip right in front of this group in the 99. There we see Kyle Busch in 5 and Dave Blaney in 82.
Greg Biffle in there starting to make his way up in the back. And Ron Hornaday in the 2. Got a new ride for next year announced this afternoon.
Yeah, who's that?
Going to drive Kevin Harvick's Craftsman truck.
Ah.
The truck team that Harvick owns.
Yeah.
Hornaday goes into that for next year.
Ooh. Right. Oh, here we go. Here we go for the lead.
This is a racy time. We got fresh tires, and Johnson wants to get up there and lead a lap. Little wiggle, little wiggle.
SpongeBob wants to try it in front.
He's going to soak up all the glory of leading.
Yeah, there you go.
There it is. New leader, Jimmy Johnson. Oh, Robbie, hang on. He's had a couple of those now.
These boys are racing hard, aren't they?
At the very top of the show, we talked about turn four wall, and I said a lot of that problem starts back in the middle of the corner. You saw what Robbie Gordon did in the 55. He did a great job, but his problem there started back in the middle of the corner, and luckily he didn't hit the wall from turn four.
It's an odd feeling here. You're into the racetrack, you're driving hard, you've got the fresh tires on, and one little bump upsets the car into a fashion to where you're up on top of the racetrack, and you're just sliding, and you just never know when it's going to catch again. This 3 and 4 is probably the most treacherous set of corners that we race on.
So Robbie Gordon, after that bump in treacherous turn four, from first to fifth, as Johnson, Bliss, Mears, and Truex all went by. Now he's trying to get one of those spots back. Oh, that's close.
You know, but Kurt, they're talking about repaving this racetrack, but when you talk to that to the drivers down the garage, it's, oh no, don't repave it because it's so much fun then.
It is fun, and Humpy's really got a big task on hand, whether to do so or not. It is a rough mile and a half. It is its own unique place. There isn't a mile and a half like it. It has such sharp corners, different banking, 1-2 versus 3 and 4. It'd be tough if they paved it.
New second place runner, Casey Mears by Mike Bliss. 41 cars start to roll back toward the front. Had a little trouble with a lug nut on his pit stop, which is what dropped him back in the pack. How about our trim spot, the envied moment? It's always a good thing when it's your sponsor's race and you put the car out front in the lead, isn't it?
Definitely.
Yeah, but old SpongeBob right now, he's got some troubles. That 41 car, Casey Mears, is really fast.
Dialed in.
How about Casey Mears would cause him to lose that track position in the pit stop, Dave?
Yeah, Alan, Matt talked about the speed of the crew who worked on the 55 car. The 41 actually had a little trouble. Right front tire changer, lost a lug nut as he was changing, was able to replace it, but it took a little time to make that change.
Oh, the battle of the fives. And believe it or not, this is for fifth place.
How about that?
Got some.
Dave?
This one goes in the strange but true category. Kyle radioed in. Guys, I never hit my brakes, but our kill switch system went off last time I went into three. That's a system they run that invented by Jack Roush that is brake activated in case the throttle sticks. He didn't hit the brakes, but it went off anyway. He was able to refire the car.
Ooh, I know about those things. I had trouble with
them.
They do if you have it set wrong, and if they're just now beginning to run those, you got to set them at a more lenient brake pressure. Even though he isn't using brakes, I'd always set him off coming down pit road. Mears has definitely got a good race car. Front pack's tied together.
So Casey Mears working on Jimmy Johnson for the race lead. When's the last time you think Jimmy Johnson led a NASCAR Busch Series race?
Well, it was 2001.
That would be correct. Want to try and narrow it in any further?
No.
Okay, how about Bristol in August of 2001?
2000 Bristol. You know, the 41 car is so fast, but your Bliss goes by.
We just saw the 41 moving forward. Here comes the 20, the 8. Got ourselves a race.
And Mike Bliss made news last week after the race. On Sunday morning, actually, I go down in the Cup garage area, and there's rumors around that Mike Bliss and Tony Stewart had words and wrestled in one of the team transfers. And NASCAR investigated and said there were some words, but that was basically about it. I talked to Steve D'Souza, the general manager for Joe Gibbs, the Busch Series, and he said those guys had words, but really and truly no blows were struck. They got something happened on the racetrack between Bliss and Tony Stewart, and they got upset, and one thing led to another.
Never knew of a history between those guys, and they're a couple open wheel guys that always race hard.
I think that might be the problem. It might go back 15 years to open wheel racing.
I talked to Mike about it earlier today, and he said, you know, something that starts out innocently on the racetrack escalates, and all of a sudden two people are mad at each other and they're really not sure why. In so many words, but that's basically what happened. Matt Kenseth squeezing in front of Robbie Gordon there. Kenseth trying to get back into it, Marty.
Yeah, and he's trying to make his way back up through the field, but the crew made a little mistake on the last stop. Matt's car was tight. They made a wedge adjustment on the first stop. They were supposed to take the wedge back out. Instead, they put a half round back in, so they're making the car tighter. Matt was not very happy when he got the word about that car. Very tight for the 17 right now.
Whoops.
Yeah.
Oops.
Well, he gets to find that out as soon as he drives off into turn one, and then he has to ask the crew. It didn't work out so good during the pit stop.
You know, our guys all the time are talking about the crew chiefs and the crews changing air pressure a pound of air pressure. Kurt, can you really, in a test, tell the difference in a half pound air pressure in a tire?
It's amazing the force that these cars throw onto the tires. You can change it just by a half a pound. You can change the camber angle by 2/10, and you have a whole different feel. And that's what is so difficult with all of these racetracks that we go to and the limited track time that we run on. You've got to get all these things dialed in, and one little half pound of pressure in the right rear acts as a spring rate to that tire, and that'll jack the spring rate up 100 pounds or so.
But that guy's not using the little silver air gauge the guy uses as at the gas station. It's a expensive air gauge.
Oh, definitely. We'll go to the tenth of a pound of pressure. I'll call over to the crew. I want a half a pound change here and a half a pound there, one to cancel one another, and then Jimmy will make another adjustment on a different tire, and it gives the car a whole different balance just by changing small increments of air pressure.
We'll get back into the field here for some side-by-side racing. Robert Presley in 47, moving through. Mike Wallace in the 4, trying to get around Blake Feast. This is going to be back in the low 20s as far as the running order is concerned.
David's trimming in the trim spot, 32.
Who, by the way, got a lucky dog pass earlier and is back on the lead lap, though has some transmission troubles. 26 car is Mark Green, and up front, Kyle Busch. Moved around Martin Truex to pick up fourth a couple of laps ago.
And trying to get by Casey Mears in 41. What's happened to this 41 car? He was looked like he was going to take the lead just a few laps ago. Now he's about to lose third. Dave, what's going on with the 41?
BP, he radioed into his crew really tight in traffic, and that's where he is now.
Okay.
That's something to keep in mind for all the cup guys tomorrow. You've got to start out with a loose car here in a cup car. Busch cars might handle differently, but once you get tight through 1 and 2 at Charlotte, you lose a tremendous amount of speed. 3 and 4 as well.
So Kyle Busch through to third spot, trying to chase down those two, Jimmy Johnson and Mike Bliss. They are the leaders as we come up on halfway of the SpongeBob SquarePants the Movie 300 at Charlotte.
Isn't measured by where he started, just where he finishes. For 22 years running, proud sponsor of the NASCAR Busch Series.
Shaking things up. The room is picked on the spot. The budget is up in the air. And the design is done on the fly. We're putting a whole new spin on Trading Spaces.
Bye, guys!
All new Saturday at 8, only on TLC.
I have so many people to thank. All those folks behind the scenes who work so hard to make my life a little easier. I mean, this baby saves people a whole lot of money.
Shop our 3-day sale. Use your preferred card for boneless, skinless chicken breasts, $1.69 a pound. Capri Sun or Sun Sport drinks, 4 for $5. And Weight Watchers Smart Ones entrees, 10 for $10.
I forgot to thank the produce guy.
Jewel, helping make your life easier.
This weekend, all the drama is on TNT. Saturday night at 8. Don't miss Sharon Stone and Sylvester Stallone in The Specialist.
Little danger never killed anybody.
And Sunday at 8, the legend lives on with Antonio Banderas in The Mask of Zorro.
Is it just one man, Zorro?
Saturday at 8, The Specialist. And Sunday at 8, The Mask of Zorro. All the drama starts tomorrow night at 8 on TNT. We know drama.
They call it the most extraordinary way to travel on land. No matter where you go, in a feather-like luxury coach. Unparalleled amenities and conveniences accompany you. Others call the feather-like coach the world's most extraordinary way to, well, party. Now is the time to own a feather-like. Or ask us about renting this incredible luxury vehicle. Enjoy.
Those kind of nights the race sponsor really enjoys. It's the SpongeBob SquarePants Movie 300 at Lowe's Motor Speedway Charlotte, and the two cars carrying the SpongeBob SquarePants paint schemes are now running 1 and 2.
SpongeBob, Patrick.
And Patrick's going for the lead.
Going for his 5 points.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking too when I saw it, Jimmy. Yeah. It kind of looked like a wave by to me. So Kyle Busch passing Mike Bliss during the commercial break for second. Now he's out in front and collecting there. 5 bonus points for leading a lap in his bid for the Busch Series Championship. Uh-oh.
Bad news for Wally.
It is not running.
Taking the helmet off and pushing the car back to the garage. Means the engine has expired.
What we're getting from pit road is an oil pump failure. And so Wally with just the two chances left to get that top five finish to keep from having to wash BP's car. I know it breaks your heart, Benny.
Oh, it does.
Here's a race for fourth place. Casey Mears continuing to slip back a little bit. And Matt Kenseth moving forward.
Car that we always see run good on long runs.
That's not a shock should that 17 go forward late in the run, is it?
That's my boy, Kenseth.
How about these numbers? The last nine NASCAR Busch Series races at Charlotte, Matt Kenseth has been in. He's led. He has six top fives in 12 career starts here. And he's won two of the last four Busch Series races here that he's been in. Pretty good?
Pretty stout.
Not bad.
Won the All-Star race here this summer, too.
Yep. All right, let's go through the field. Start with our leader just past halfway, Kyle Busch. Dave?
He passed his teammate Jimmy Johnson, but before doing so, they asked him, do you think we need to get away by it? Kyle said, nah, we'll just pass him. And he did. Matt?
Jimmy Johnson has won non-points cup victory here, has a points-paying victory. Now I would like to add a NASCAR Busch Series victory to his racing resume. He hasn't said anything about the race car, Marty, since the last stop.
Matty, a few weeks ago, Mike Bliss tested here, paying off right now. The car a little bit tight. He says we're killing the right rear, but we're very fast. 140 is when the 20 car should pit. Matt Kenseth suffering through that tight race car. I believe it's a little bit of anger to his crew as to why he's driving so well. Same car he won with at Texas. Very good all throughout practice yesterday. Good right now, too, Dave.
Martin Truex's crew tried to fix that tight into turn three situation with an air pressure adjustment on the last stop. The car now is loose going into the corner and tight the middle off. They may have hurt his off-the-corner run. Matt?
What a night Greg Biffle has had. He started at the back, pitted early, started at the back again. He's now made his way into the top 10 since the car is a little on the tight side. They're talking about a track bar adjustment, Dave, for the next stop.
Matt, as I mentioned earlier, the 41 fighting a tight situation in traffic, but they're also tracking something they've been looking at since early in the race, a little vibration in the motor area. Nothing reported recently. Matt, back to you.
Robbie Gordon, the 55 car, lacking grip, both front and rear, just sliding the nose. They made a wedge and track bar adjustment and air pressure adjustment on that last stop. And Dave Blaney in the 82 car this week, best finish here at Lowe's of third. He says the car a little on the tight side, but very good. He likes it on the tight side. Marty.
Matt Bobby Labonte finished ninth in his last Busch Series race. That was at California. Right now, he's running 10th. A little too loose, says Bobby. He said he just can't arc it into the corner like he would like, but making steady progress to the field after you see starting 16th. Alan.
There are your top 10. 33 cars on the lead lap. Kyle Busch, the eighth different driver to lead the race tonight. He took the lead just past halfway and has moved out by 6/10 of a second on second place Jimmy Johnson. We keep going through the field. 11th place Kevin Harvick is Matt.
Harvick started the night in the eighth position, says he just can't get in the gas when he needs to. He feels like it's rolling over on the right front. He just can't arc it like he needs as well. Ricky Vires, his crew chief, went only half the adjustments that they made on the first stop because they feel like they're going in the right direction. And also Clint Bowyer, who will take over the two car next year. He's very pleased with his Kevin Harvick race car, same car that Tony Stewart scored a top five finish with here in the spring. A little on the tight side, Marty.
Kenny Wallace had a nice little run tonight. Currently, he's up in towards the top 10. His car is a little bit loose, and then it goes tight. Just like Kurt was saying, you got to start your car loose, and then it gets better the longer he runs. Behind him, Sterling Marlin started 31st, currently up close to the top 10. Loose going into three, but good off the corner set. Don't touch it too much. Very happy with the car, Dave.
Marty, Ron Hornaday is losing spots. He lost two on that last lap. His car is very, very tight. It was loose at the beginning of this race. They've gone just a little bit too far on their adjustments. Marty, back at you.
Dave, the last adjustment for David Green didn't work out too well. He said it hasn't helped that much. Car still loose in for David. He runs very well at this racetrack. Two top tens in his last four Charlotte starts. Dave?
25 car of Mike McLaughlin as he goes down to the inside of David Green. His biggest complaint all night is that the motor is sluggish. The handling has been fine, but a little trouble on the power plant. Matt?
Jamie McMurray, his fourth start in Rusty Wallace's number 66 car, says the car is back on the tight side, but boy, it sure does have a motor. They made an air pressure adjustment out of both left side tires, Marty.
Matt, the 11th ever stock car race for Aaron Fiken, doing a pretty good job. Car is tight from the center off, and it gets better the longer he runs. He's fairly happy with it. They're just kind of skating on top of the racetrack in 19th right now, Matty.
Rounding out the top 20 is Michael Waltrip in the 99 car. He's had a tough night, still has that cosmetic damage to that right front. In fact, he says maybe we should have fixed that on that last stop, Alec.
So there you go, the top 20. Just past the midway point of the race with Kyle Busch out in front trying to gain maximum points on the night if he can in his pursuit of the NASCAR Busch Series Championship. You're watching NASCAR on TNT.
Ryan Newman drives just like you. He warms up the car. Fights his way through traffic. And hurries home at the end of the day. That's why he depends on Mobil 1 for advanced wear protection. Nothing outperforms Mobil 1, the official motor oil of NASCAR, specially formulated for today's trucks and SUVs.
Dry rinse polymer soap. Pure filter technology. Mr. Clean Auto Dry Car Wash. Spot-free shine with no need to dry. Guaranteed.
From Lowe's Motor Speedway, Charlotte, this Friday night. Good crowd on hand watching the NASCAR Busch Series at the 120 lap mark of 200 in the distance. Kyle Busch, the race leader, another driver in the garage, is with Matt.
And we've caught up with Wally. Now Benny is already smiling, knowing that you only have two more chances so that you can try to win the bet.
Let him enjoy it while he can. We're going to get him at Phoenix and Homestead.
What happened?
Looks like we pitched the oil pump belt, and the engine locked up. It locked up pretty quick. It gets real tight. Kurt will tell you what that's like. It's just, at first I saw the double zero car just pulling away from me. I'm like, man, those guys have horsepower. And then it blew up. But the car was really, really tight. But that last stop, we made a big gain on it. And we're just going to keep working on it. But I think it's done for sure.
Are you going to take a sip of your drink now? Where's your Wally's water?
I sold my only bottle of Wally water. So that's the only one I had.
Did you pay him to take it, or did you get money for it?
Got 50 cents for it, but the labeling cost me 75 cents, so I lost.
Typical Wally deal. He lost money.
Matt, you got to be careful giving Wally a hard time with Mr. Clean standing behind you.
I wouldn't mess with him.
He's bigger than you. I can tell you how some of those things work out.
As Kyle Busch, the 5 car, lapped the 91 of Stanton Barrett, it allowed the 48 of Johnson to close in back on the back bumper.
And behind them, the two drivers that have been putting the fastest lap times in this last 10 or 15 lap segment, Matt Kenseth and Greg Biffle, are closing.
Those blue oval Fords, teammates of mine. And you always can count on Kenseth and Biffle to run good on long runs, especially in their Busch cars.
They got some ground to make up to get there, but there comes Kenseth, 17.
And there goes Biffle.
Yep.
Right now, Biffle is a little over 4 seconds behind Kyle Busch.
Got a caution. There you go, debris in turn four. They've been talking about it for a couple of minutes. Where was it? Was it above the line, below the line? And they decided discretion was the better part of the issue at the moment.
We're in a situation now that, you know, we talked about the pit window. We saw that earlier on. I said 65 to 70 laps. Well, when they make this pit stop, there's going to be about 75 laps to go. Somebody is going to try to make it, save a little fuel, and try to make that last 75 laps.
It'll be interesting. I would have thought that teams were going to begin to prepare what they were going to work on during their stops under green. Now they've got a little bit of time. They're under yellow, and it is a bit short to the end, but you'll definitely come down pit road and get and grab as much fuel as you can.
Pit road will be open.
Yeah, you've got to stop the fuel. It's 46 laps.
I hear something about Jimmy.
That was the Kyle Busch team.
Yeah, we're coming.
It's been 46 laps since the last pit stops. You got to come in and get fuel.
Oh, yeah, 70 miles.
Question is, do you take that last set of tires you're allowed to change under caution?
That's the question.
We're coming. Four tires.
There you go. Question asked, question answered. That's Lance McGrew telling his driver, Kyle Busch, four tires.
He'll be the one to set the tone for the rest of pit road.
Everybody follow it.
This is going to be so tough on that fuel, BP. 76 to go for the stops.
Mm.
Wow. All right, Marty.
Maybe the 17 guys should go the wrong way more often because Matt was pretty fast at the end of that run. A little bit tight to start off with. He said, we're going to kill him at the end of the run here. So they go four tires and no changes. They are 14 laps short of making it all the way on fuel, Matt.
SpongeBob, in the center of your screen, they've already made a track bar adjustment. The car, a little free and clean air. It feels really good when he's in traffic. No wrenches going into the leader's car. Slight air pressure adjustment, if at all. A little tighter at the end of that run. He stalls the car trying to get off pit road. He refires, but he will not win the race off pit road.
Might get second, though. Be close between he and Mike Bliss, but Jimmy Johnson's going to reassume the lead on these pit stops. Sets up a fuel mileage derby to the finish as Johnson edges his Hendrick Motorsports teammate off of the pit lane. Ooh, we'll let the officials call that one.
See Sylvester Stallone.
God, no mercy.
And Sharon Stone.
You mean me?
In a movie so explosive, it had to be a new classic. Watch The Specialist tomorrow at 8 on TNT.
And here at Lowe's Motor Speedway Charlotte, getting ready to go back racing. With Jimmy Johnson, the new leader, off the pit lane. Kyle Busch, when he left his pit stall, a little fireworks for us.
That's pretty spectacular. You might have seen the sparks, folks. As he left, watch the right rear tire. He's going to stall the engine when he leaves. Gas man and the catch can man is signaling, I'm ready to stall. And watch the right rear. See those sparks? That was a lug nut, one of the loose lug nuts, and he ran over and kicked that thing back down pit road.
Look out.
Everybody hit by one of those?
I'm in the car, but I have been on pit road standing watching some of the Busch races, and those things come whizzing by you. I don't really know what we can do to help try to fix that problem. They're just laying there. They were on the tire, yep. And you got the new ones glued onto the wheel already.
Never seen Kyle in second spot.
So getting ready to go back racing with Kyle trailing now Jimmy Johnson, Mike Bliss third, Robbie Gordon fourth, Matt Kenseth fifth, followed by Casey Mears, Martin Truex, Sterling Marlin, Mike McLaughlin, and Clint Bowyer up to 10th place.
Here we go, cars lined up. And Kurt's pointing out Greg Biffle is back in 28th spot. Must have had something on pit road that happened.
I'm waving my flag, but I didn't know what to say.
Yeah.
Poor Biffle had a terrible stop.
Made two pit stops, I'm told.
Huh.
Okay. All right. Oh, the white car. Is that Ashton Lewis? Yes, Ashton Lewis had some trouble down in 1 and 2, and that car's both sides, all around him.
Yo, hang on. That's so close when they get in that corner, and the guy in the bottom starts sliding up like that.
It's a tough place to race. When you got fresh tires, though, it's something where you can make maneuvers and move forward, but it's really, really tough if your car isn't dialed in on fresh tires because people blow by you.
So, 72 laps to go, and the question is, will another caution come out? Will this become a fuel mileage derby? Can anybody make it to the finish on the gas they have on board?
That's an awfully good question.
And who's willing to gamble?
And that brings up the topic of running at a treacherous pace right now. You don't want to run too hard, BP, because you'll burn your tires off quick. You know that this is going to be a long run. You know you might be able to make it to the end on fuel, but you're not going to run that hard at the beginning of this run, are you?
We don't know about the fuel, but we do know they can't change tires again. That's a known.
Very good.
Under caution.
Under caution. Now they can stop if they got to stop on green, but if they run till they're out of fuel, it's only going to be 4 or 5 laps, so then they'll just get a splash of gas, just a few gallons to get them to the end. Matt, what about it? Are they going to try to make it to the end?
BP, a couple teams on my end of pit road came back in to top off. Michael Waldrop as well as Greg Biffle. Brad Parrish says we are good to go.
Okay.
That's why he's back there.
Okay.
All right, so now let's turn around and talk tires. Driver,
remember,
you got to run 74.
Laps here.
There you go.
You got 75 laps to run on this set of tires. What are you doing behind the wheel with the pedals and so on to try and help yourself?
You don't want to make any aggressive movements on the wheel. If you get into the corner too hard, that's a no-no. If you get on the gas too soon and you push that right rear into the track and ask for forward bite and side bite at the same time, it's going to wear that right rear tire out. If you get in the corner too hard, that's a no-no. That wears your right front tire out because you're trying to corner and develop that speed through the corner. You just have to be nice and ginger with all four of your tires.
Casey Mears running in fifth place, Dave.
Oh, here he comes down pit road.
Right front tire, guys. In fact, at the last run, the other thing that Casey Mears radioed to his crew was exactly what Kurt alluded to. Guys, I use up my tires too early. Unfortunately, he's not going to have a chance on this set as the right front tire goes down. He will come all the way slowly down pit road under green and change two right side tires, guys. This is going to kill him. They had a very, very fast race car. Here he comes now, finally makes his way into the pit stall. They go around to the right side. Casey could feel it in the car, the way it was handling. They will change those two right sides top off. This could take them to the end on fuel, but they've already gone one lap down as he leaves pit road.
Tough, wow. Tough break. Very fast race car, sat on the pole, led laps early. Won't be able to seal the deal.
Remember last week at Kansas, Casey was leading, running well in the race. When, oh, trouble, turn two. Is that Ashton Lewis? It is.
We saw him have trouble at the beginning of that run. He just wasn't up to pace.
Run over by your buddy in the 26 car.
Somebody knocked him up into
He got a toe-out issue there, BP.
Yes, he does.
He had bounced off somebody and had that right front fender pushed around earlier when he was struggling in traffic there, and obviously the problems have worsened.
Well, the left front's pointing south and the right front's pointing north. Not a good combination.
Not at all.
Yeah.
You can hear him all the way up here.
Yeah.
All right, let's check it out.
The 26 car, Mark Green, is on pit road.
Right side of the screen.
Yeah, there we see the 26 go up and makes contact with the left front, just kind of knocked the 46 up in the wall.
That might have been Aaron Fike in the 43 that was in tight there with Mark Green in the 26. And Lewis going to go to the garage.
Yeah, he turned it too early, but he barely can drive it. He's lucky to be where he is.
This is an interesting yellow as far as making it to the end, isn't it?
Yeah, what do you do? Come in and take that splash of fuel?
Or does this yellow flag pace allow your car to get better fuel mileage? It's always the question.
These questions and more answered when we continue from Lowe's Motor Speedway, Charlotte. Not Matt Kenseth.
Stayed on the racetrack. McLaughlin stayed out. But here come the first five or six cars on the pit road.
Looks like we got the 50-50 club here, BP, huh?
Bliss, just a little splash of gas. 40 in car, Matt.
BP, a lot of debate for Jimmy Johnson. They're going to give him a good splash of gas, a slight track bar adjustment, and he's away. Dave.
Five car of Kyle Busch, fuel only, comes to a nice slow stop in the pit. They clean the grill. He'll go on the command of the crew chief. He leaves, does not stall it this time. Marty?
Oh, man, oh, man.
The stop sign was up.
Damage to the right front on that five car.
There is a big moment in this race.
Look at the right front. Eight car squeezed me into the 20. What else would you get from a championship contender?
A little frustration. There is a big moment in this race.
Obviously, they can't see it as well as we can, but Kurt, it looks to me like he's got to come back in and get it off that tire.
I would say so. I mean, they already threw away the track position by coming in. And one thing we were going to touch on was the 5 and the 8 were on pit road together. So neither one of them were going to gain different positions by this. And he just wasn't looking at the stop sign. 8 car didn't didn't have much to do with it, but both of them were looking at one another.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm running for you in points. Hey, I'm running against you in points.
Oh, the 20 stopped in front of us.
And there's a stop sign.
Oh, he was trying to beat the 8 car down pit road.
They both were trying to beat one another.
Uh-huh.
That's the toughest call as a driver. You never want to come in just to top off with fuel. Everybody's in for 2 seconds. They're out of their pit box quickly. And here comes Kyle Busch back down the pit road. They got to work on that fender.
Got to get off that tire. I think once he goes in the corner, it's going to hit. And
probably... All right, we just got to fix that fender.
All right. Is Patrick a starfish?
Yes.
Is he? He's
probably smiling a lot more than the driver inside that car is right now. Dave, here he comes.
Starfish making its way onto pit road and into its pit box. Remember on the beginning of this race, Kyle started 18th and marched his way to the front. The 5 car can definitely do it tonight. The crew tries to pound out the right front fender, get it back into shape, as well as get it off the tire. Because, Kurt, as you know, having that right front planted here at this track is pretty important.
Tough break.
It was a tough break.
It was a mistake, and just with the way pit road is, when you come in for stop and go, that stop sign is going to be up, or the gas and go, stop sign is going to be up.
So let's see, we have 11 cars that did not pit. Kenseth McLaughlin, Bowyer, Kenny Wallace, McMurray, David Green, Hornaday, Harvick, Biffle, Waltrip, Justin Labonte did not pit. Then you get Jimmy Johnson in 12th, Bliss and Truex in 13th and 14th, and we'll check where Kyle's going to line up. It's probably going to be back around 22nd or so for this restart.
There's a little ways to go. He's got a car that'll run on the long run, but this is a hole that he's got to dig out of very patiently.
But, and how much does that fender damage affect the handling of his car?
That's another question.
So here we go.
McLaughlin didn't get a very good restart.
I'll tell you what, the red and white car on the inside, LaJoy might be getting a red flag. I told him he is getting a red flag because he beat the leader to the line on the restart.
We'll be getting the black flag for jumping the restart. So Randy LaJoy will get a pass through. Kyle Busch, sorry, Kurt, 26th on this restart.
What this does is it allows Kenseth to just stretch his lead out. They've got 2nd through 10th, 11th, that stayed out on the racetrack, and those cars were running before this caution back at 18th through 25th, so they're not up to the pace that Jimmy Johnson and some of the leaders were before. But you can't go anywhere when it's too wide in front of you.
That's probably what they have now. We see Jimmy Johnson back there right behind Greg Biffle alongside Ron Hornaday. By now, they finally got some clean racetrack in front of them if they will run on the outside of their car to work out there.
Mark Green about to rejoin the race. His team changed tires under the caution flag when they had used up all of their tires. It's a lap penalty per set per tire that you change. It's in addition to what's allowed, so a 3-lap penalty for Mark Green. Joy is in for his pass-through penalty. Here's Kyle Busch back in 26th place is where he restarted. He's already picked up 4 spots. He's in 22nd and working on Mike Wallace for 21st.
Oh! I just knew he was going to run the back of the 4 car because he had a head of steam coming off turn 4 in that 5.
It is, though. He ran a lap time of 30.7 that lap. Yeah, he did check up for the 4 a little bit, but our leaders are running much quicker than that.
30.3 last time for Matt Kenseth out in the clean air and free of traffic. But does Kenseth have enough fuel to go to the finish?
That's a question. Watch those top 10.
How many laps of caution was that last one?
Give it a shot. There, Truex, the 8 car, trying to work his way forward. Michael Waltrip, Truex is back in 10th position. Oh, trouble.
A smoker. David Stremme, caution flag is out. Maybe that transmission finally gave up.
And the 5 car was right behind Stremme.
That was the transmission that they had talked about earlier. They were having problems, and they said they'd go as long as they could.
Yeah, on board with him. It's cloudy.
This we do not envy.
Looks like it might rain.
Man,
hopefully there's no oil that was coming out in that smoke that got on Kyle's windshield or some of those other guys that ran through the smoke.
That's what I was thinking about when the five car was right behind him, that he may have a windshield full of oil. Remember last year when your car had some smoke and it finally blew up?
Yeah.
You remember this?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, definitely. Scary moment. The fire, it just jumped inside the car. And one of those circumstances, I've never actually had a situation like this. The spotter told me to go over to where the fire truck was in turn two. I jumped out as quick as I could. Got some of those fumes. Not a really pretty moment.
That was the oil on the floor pan that was burning, right?
We had an oil leak, and it came in through our oil tank in the back, and we had an oil line explode underneath the car, and finally it seized up the motor because it didn't have oil pressure. But thank goodness for my safety equipment and the Alpine Star suit I was wearing. I didn't get burned.
No takers on pit road this time among the front runners, so we will take a break with 57 laps to go here at Charlotte. Interesting circumstances setting up for the finish of this one. This race brought out by this.
Davis Trimming, 32 car. You can hear all kinds of noise as he comes off the corner. Listen.
Transmission failure.
Rear flat probably here.
Tranny blew up.
Trimming said the tranny blew up.
10-4, just pull it straight to the garage.
And still cleaning up some of the bits and pieces and liquid and so forth from the Stremme car, so we remain under the yellow flag. Matt Kenseth is the race leader. Marty is with his crew chief.
And you should have heard the collective sigh of relief when that caution came out. Cully, can you now make it all the way to the end?
Every yellow helps, just a few more, indefinitely.
And how's the car been?
A little tight early, but as we go, it gets faster. That's why we decided to stay out.
And it gets faster and a little bit looser, and that should actually help with the fuel mileage. Dave?
Checking in with Lance McGrew, crew chief for Kyle Busch. What's he said about the car? Little damage, but now it looks like you might have the fuel to go to the end.
Nah, we're fine. We had a little fender damage on pit road. We got into the 20 car right there at the end of pit road. But, you know, that happens on pit road sometimes. We just come in, topped off with fuel, kind of a little accident going out, so we had to go back to the back. But he picked off eight cars there in about four laps. So he's a little frustrated being in the back, but the car's really good.
I mean, it was good in traffic before. He marched to the front, so what about now?
Oh, I don't feel like it shouldn't be a whole lot of trouble, and I still think there's quite a few people. If we get some green flag run here, I don't think there's a lot of these guys can make it.
It's going to be fun watching Kurt's younger brother, guys.
Oh, and they're still dumping the oil dry around Lowe's Motor Speedway, so we've got a little more cleanup to go. We'll take a break, come back. Matt Kenseth is the race leader here on TNT.
Are the brake pads and shoes really guaranteed for as long as I own my car?
Yes.
What if I need additional work?
We'll explain it all before we do anything.
In a written estimate?
Yes.
Could you read that last answer back for me, please?
Yes.
Visit Midas now and get brake pads or shoes for just $39.95 plus installation. We'll provide a written estimate for installation and fully explain any additional work needed. For mechanics known for their work and their word,
trust the Midas touch.
Those who never quit, the battery that never quits, Energizer, keep going.
It's our latest construction, Reese's White Chocolate, creamy white chocolate, smooth Reese's Peanut Butter. Get lost in a Reese's White Chocolate.
Yippee!
Who knows how to say most valuable player? Yes.
El jugador más valioso.
Very good. El jugador más valioso. What about three championships? Yes.
Tres campeonatos.
Excelente. Tres campeonatos. What about most dominant center ever? Yes.
Yao Ming.
Yao Ming?
Bill Russell?
Go to the principal's office.
Nothing is more dramatic than the truth. Season starts November 2nd.
Hi, I'm Keith Hernandez.
And I'm Walt Clyde Frazier.
What a marvelous night for the action.
Let's go to the play-by-play.
Oh, there's Mr. Greybeard approaching Miss Hottie. Oh, no.
Rejected.
Clyde, that's got to hurt.
Yeah, no play for Mr. Grey. Get that man our Just a Man Brush In Color Gel.
It's specially formulated to penetrate coarse facial hair and gets rid of gray in 5 easy minutes.
Gets rid of strikeouts, too. Just for me and Joe.
The Rejuvenator.
To every crew member living on 3 hours sleep, we pledge to trim a hundredth of a second off the next lap. To our fans who drive all night to cheer us to victory, we pledge to go three wide into the turn without fear. To every kid whose favorite number is 48, we pledge to trade paint with the best of them. We are Lowe's, and this is our pledge. Proud sponsor of Team 48, and everyone who plans to finish strong on Sunday.
The SpongeBob SquarePants Movie 300 from Lowe's Motor Speedway on TNT is brought to you by SpongeBob SquarePants the Movie. By Best Western, wherever NASCAR takes you, Best Western is there. Best Western, the official hotel of NASCAR. By Goodyear Assurance, featuring triple tread technology. And by Just for Men, more than a hair color, it's the Rejuvenator. Ends gray in 5 minutes.
Last week, broke his leg and not a hair out of place.
I thanked the lady for the poster at Kansas last week. I got a chuckle out of that sitting on the couch.
Last week, a poster said, Alan, sorry about your leg. How's your hair?
Hair all survived just fine. Thank you very much. Leg, on the other hand, is another story.
They sell that stuff just outside of Fenway, don't they? I know they do it in Chicago.
All right. Still cleaning up all that oil dry put down. Let's take advantage to get another break out of the way so we can show you as much of this green flag racing toward the finish as we can. Through the SpongeBob SquarePants Movie 300. SpongeBob characters greeting the drivers, including pole sitter Casey Mears on stage before we cut him loose under green.
Jason Keller on lap four loses it off turn two. Almost saves it, but not quite in the inside retaining wall.
First of eight caution flags we've had in the race so far tonight. Lap 37, second yellow. This was a race for the lead.
Joe Nemechek, 88, loses control, hard contact. He is out for the night.
Race off pit road was interesting under the yellow. Truex engine Casey Mears to get some bonus points for leading a few laps. We move ahead to the third caution flag.
A little bit of help from behind.
Yeah, 87 car Boston Reed gets tapped by Tim Fiedel in 12 and around he goes.
Reed has continued in the race. Now, Jimmy Johnson moved up through the pack from his 20th starting spot, took the lead from Robbie Gordon out in front until his teammate, Kyle Busch, went by just past halfway.
Bunch of characters they are.
Yeah. Then some troubles on a pit stop for Kyle. Little trouble getting away from his pit box. Lost the lead on that exchange of visits to pit road. Casey Mears gave up a top five spot under green.
Flat right front tire.
And we had contact. 46, Aston Lewis just out on the bummer end of that deal.
And a big moment championship-wise. Race off pit road. Kyle Busch runs up into the back of Mike Bliss when the stop sign was up at the end of pit road. Had to come back in for repairs. Went back to 26th place. He's worked his way back to 20th now. And then this most recent caution that's caused so much cleanup. Oil, debris, bits, pieces from David Stremme's transmission. And finally, we're just about through with the cleanup. Matt Kenseth, the race leader, and let's check in down on pit road.
Jamie McMurray runs in the fourth position. Barry, size up your fuel situation.
I tell you what, Maddie, we're just going to have to log on and see. We're not racing for points, we're racing for wins. And when we started this scenario with 75 to go, that's unlikely for us, and we didn't think it would work. Since then, we've had two more cautions, and we're real close. We're very, very close. Tell you what, the team's really been focused tonight. I've never heard so much talk. Rusty upstairs, Jamie in the car, Blake, the whole crew's done a great job, and we're just racing to win. We've got to see what's going to happen.
Restart for McMurray, and he waited till after the start finish line.
Man, did he ever get by the 33 of Clint Boyer and tried to go by McLaughlin in the 25.
Now Kevin Harvick racing a car that he owns. Harvick and Richard Childress is 21, and that 33 is a car that he owns. Clint Boyer.
Jimmy Johnson, 48, trying to go by the 60 of Biffle and Boyer.
That's a huge pass if he makes it, because those two may be the fastest cars on the track.
That's why they're racing one another pretty hard. On the outside, it's tough to stick in one and two, but Biffle manhandled that car through the corner. See if the 48 can get a run. this is what makes this track so great, is you're able to race on both ends. Biffle just skimming across the top of those jumps.
Right now, this is for sixth place.
We got a crash. Got Aaron Fack in the 43 car. Pretty heavy contact.
Yeah.
Yeah. Man. On the hood of the car is Leanne Rhyme, so we did not treat her nicely.
Tough hit for Aaron Fike, who has had a couple of bruisers this year in the NASCAR Busch Series.
See Aaron moving around in the car. You also see water coming out from the car, so he has broken the radiator. He's going to make contact with the 91 car and get turned head on in the wall. 91 is Stanton Barrett.
Too many cars in one spot.
Did not have the lane he wanted available to him.
Definitely was a car on his outside. He's got no air on his nose following the double zero that close. And that turn for a while, I didn't hit it that hard today, but that was definitely a hit. Definitely a hit you didn't want to have.
I'll agree, you didn't hit it that hard.
Nice to see that when they put the safer barriers in at this racetrack, they put them all the way down this front stretch side, because you have some hard hits here.
Mm-hmm. As witnessed by Aaron Fike's crash. And he has gotten out of the car. Waves the crowd.
Coming at you.
But one thing that you see that NASCAR has done is that section of the track where I brushed the wall today and where Aaron had some contact, there is no soft wall in that position. It actually goes back to the flush concrete, and then they bring it in again through the trioval section. If they did take away 30 inches, 36 inches of the racetrack there, every single car in happy hour would have hit it. This place is very tough off of turn four, but they had to give us that dog leg in there so that we could still have the general line off the corner.
Stan Barrett's car on pit road. His crew getting a look at the damage there. And the ninth caution flag is out in this race, further giving the guys who didn't stop for fuel before a little margin of cushion to make it to the checkered flag. Motor Speedway on a Friday night, NASCAR on TNT, with five NASCAR Busch Series racing just past the three-quarter mark of tonight's 300-miler and under caution for a ninth time. How about our Stacker 2 track fact? Drivers starting ninth or better have won the last nine NASCAR Busch Series races here at Lowe's Motor Speedway. But only one of those races has been won for the pole. In fact, only one of the last 23 races here has been won for the pole. Who would you think that would be? Who started on the pole and won a Busch Series race here?
Junior.
How about Matt Kenseth?
On the pole?
Yeah.
You got that confused with somebody.
Well, you know when he qualifies good, you better watch out in the race.
There you go. So there you go. Our Stacker 2 track back, Kenny Wallace in the Stacker 2 car in the top 10 tonight, eighth position right now as we work this caution flag. Boy, they have had to put some oil dry down.
Yes, they have. And Matt Kenseth started 13th today, so he could blow that whole Stacker 2 track back.
Chase for the next L Cup continues tomorrow night, 7 o'clock from here at Lowe's Motor Speedway. NBC is the place, and Kurt Busch will lead the field into that as the championship leader.
Sounds pretty good.
500 miles at this place, that's a tough task.
Definitely is. Always up on the wheel and slipping and sliding. It's always a fun place to race.
Speaking of championship, let's talk NASCAR Busch Series Championship with Dave.
With Kevin Mandy, now crew chief for the 8 car. Driver says he can get to the front in about 10 laps. That's pretty optimistic, but you got a good car?
Well, it is pretty optimistic. I told him he's got, at that time it was 55 laps. Now it's 42 laps. We had a lot of cautions. We probably could have made it on gas along with everyone else that stopped. So everyone's probably a little frustrated that them guys made a fuel mileage just out of this thing. But I still think we can get up there and get a good top five, and then we'll see what happens.
All right, they've been having a lot of fun on the radio, Matt.
Barry Dodson and the team still trying to calculate Jimmy McMurray's fuel mileage. They feel like they are good to go now. The only word, they need three more laps if they get a green-white checkered. So now they're trying to bank on the green-white checkered, because the way this race is going, guys, you never know.
We could see one the way it's been. Bobby Labonte out there running under caution, hoping he has enough city.
A huge banking center.
The big building is Bank of America headquarters.
Big Wachovia right beside of it.
And just a little bit away, just outside the northeastern limits of the city, in Concord, North Carolina, sits Lowe's Motor Speedway, where tomorrow night, better than 160,000 will be on hand to watch the NASCAR Nextel Cup Series, and a pretty good crowd tonight for the NASCAR Busch Series. Race about to get back underway as the field is getting the one-to-go signal. By the way, NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series, Texas Motor Speedway, tomorrow afternoon, 2 Eastern Time, Speed Channel has the live coverage.
Have they qualified down there yet?
Yes, they did. And next you're going to ask me who's on pole.
Yeah.
That I don't know.
Oh!
You had to put me in that corner, huh? I know one thing.
What?
We can go to Matt Yoakum right now.
That gets out of trouble?
Yeah.
Hey, Matt.
BP.
Yes.
I'm going to catch up with rookie Busch Series crew chief, as Mike Skinner's on the pole for the truck race. What about this team for tonight? What do you think?
You know, obviously the SpongeBob SquarePants, the movie, Monte Carlo's doing great this evening.
Say that three times fast.
That's a tough one. That's a mouthful. That's going to be a neat movie. Everybody needs to go see that on Thanksgiving weekend. I think that's going to be a lot of fun. But, you know, the car's running really well. Jimmy's doing a great job. I pitted right there because we were short on fuel. We were going to need about 12 to 15 laps of caution to make it. Well, guess what? We've had about 18, so we would have made it. But, you know, so these guys up ahead of us are sitting fine with fuel. But I think our car's a little bit faster than everybody up there and about on par with Matt. So we've got a shot at the victory, and we'll see what we can do.
You know, BP, even with that call, I think as a rookie crew chief here, I think he's got a big future in this. What do you think?
I think so, too. Great calls.
Here we go. Green flag, 38 laps to go. Jimmy Johnson sitting back in sixth place.
There's the restart line right there. All right, name it.
Matt Kenseth, Mike McLaughlin, Jamie McMurray, Kevin Harvick, Clint Bowyer, the top five. Jimmy Johnson quickly on the move.
I think Clint Bowyer in the 33 car missed the shift or didn't do it cleanly because he stumbled just past the start finish line.
Struggled on the restart last time. Harvick was able to squeak by him.
Google
the cars back here.
Mike Bliss trying to get around Kenny Wallace up front. Jamie McMurray, Kevin Harvick, third and fourth place. Harvick trying to get it away from McMurray, and he does.
On the move, that car runs at the beginning of a run.
Biffle gets by the 33. Now we see the Michael Waltrip, the 99 car, gets by Kenny Wallace.
Looks like Kenny got a little turnaround shuffle there.
Looks like Blaney's going to try to get by him, the 82 car.
Oh, I just heard the rev chip. That's so odd. Getting into turn three, it is go time. There's 37 laps to go. Everybody can make it on fuel. It's time to gain some positions.
Second place, Harvick now working on Mike McLaughlin. Harvick in the 21, McLaughlin in the 25. McLaughlin got some track position up the front when they did not hit under that caution a little bit earlier, but he's held on to it. The 25 car, Dave.
And they knew they were, we mentioned that sluggish motor a little earlier, so a little down in horsepower perhaps, just holding his line, trying to maintain positions. And Mike McLaughlin has done a great job since taking over this ride some five races ago. A second place at Dover and 11th at California and Kansas, and running well again here tonight. Matt?
Dave, Kevin Harvick working all over the back of the 25 car. They have made significant adjustments every stop tonight. The car has been free. Ricky Vyers says they just keep making small gains. Harvick has never won here. His best finish actually came here in May when he finished third.
Hey, Matt, tell Ricky Vyers tonight he's the ball.
You got it, BP.
We'll let you know the joke, a conversation going back a couple of years where Ricky asked about how you get your car on TV, and then he said, be the ball. Be what's happening on the racetrack. Be the ball. They're on the ball tonight.
They are.
Is that what happened when I bounced off turn four? I was the ball.
You were the ball at that moment.
Gotcha.
And right at this moment, your younger brother's the ball.
Look at that.
As Kyle tries to come back up through the traffic.
That's 15th. He just moved by Hornaday four as Bobby Labonte in the back of the car pulls in behind Hornaday.
Little Patrick's on the move, trying to cover up the little mistake and move forward. He's got a little bit of time, and Truex is running ninth right now, so there is a little bit of a loss in points. But Kyle's on the move.
Trouble!
Look out!
Labonte gets
Mike Wallace.
I'm sorry, I said Bobby Labonte. That was Tim Fedor. My bad.
Oh boy, damage. He got the inside wall, didn't he?
Looks like it. Finally turn the engine off. You see the engine?
I'd say he's a little hot inside the race car.
I go in the garage.
That's too bad.
So this should be caution number 10 in this race. Still a couple away from the record, by the way.
Man, such a great start to it.
I know.
Flat left sides there on Mike Wallace.
Yeah, caused by the spin.
Look at the smoke still hanging in the air. Okay, BP, do your thing.
Courtesy, we see the contact there between Jimmy Spencer in 74 and Fedaway in 12. And Fedaway just nails the gas trying to get the car to spin around, but what it did was drive straight down into the inside wall.
Ended up running into the inside wall, and it, whether Wallace had help or not, I'm sure he did. He was just trying to avoid the circumstance. And there we have Spencer into the 12. Justin Labonte's able to squeak by, as well as 47. I know this. Robert Presley. Blake Fleece.
Oh, that's who he ran into. The 14 car of Casey Atwood. Wasn't the inside wall.
That's his teammate, isn't it?
Yep.
Unfortunate.
Double damage for Fitz Bradshaw Racing. So Mike Wallace getting some fresh tires and heading back out onto the track. And let's hear from the second place crew chief, Mike McLaughlin's team. Dave?
And that is Harold Holly. Harold, how did you know there were going to be all these cautions and then you could make it on fuel, sir?
Well, I didn't. the motor's kind of flat. We're just really struggling, so track position's all we could do, and we're just gambling on plenty of cautions, and fortunately we've got them, so we should be good at the end. Mikey's just doing an awesome job, and the team Marines Ford Tours. Hopefully things will go well, and we'll get all 22 gallons, and we'll make it to the end.
I mean, it looks like it's handling pretty well.
Yeah, he's handling pretty well. The car's been a little bit tight most of the night. We got it freed up, but like I say, just a little flat on the get-go, and maybe it'll be all work out okay and everything will be fine.
Very good. Down pit road to match.
And Ricky Vyers, your car's faded a bit. What's Kevin saying about the 21?
Right now, with these longer runs, we're starting to have, he's getting a little bit loose again like it was earlier in the race. It's been really loose all night. The recent Chevrolet's just been extremely loose, and we've done major changes to tighten it up. It's the best it's been right now, and we've got really good track position, so we're hoping it'll be a quick run here to the end. Maybe we finish in the top five anyway.
And remember, they have not won since Las Vegas back in March, guys.
So Kevin Harvick hanging in fourth position. Pretty good matchup on TBS tomorrow with college football. The UCLA Bruins and the number 8 California Golden Bears. 7 o'clock Eastern time. College football, TBS, tomorrow night.
Was that California that almost beat the USC?
Yeah. Came close.
That was the team that beat them last year, yep.
They
big Pac-10
right.
fan.
Are you?
I try to hang out with those guys.
You're a West Coaster.
From the word go, I didn't have much of a choice.
Yeah. All right, one to go is the signal. So we're going to get a restart with 29 laps to go. And see if there's enough green flag laps for Jimmy Johnson to do anything with these two cars in front of him and for Kyle Busch to get through some of the traffic. And what will become of Greg Biffle? And will anybody run out of fuel toward the end?
No. Good gracious, we've had enough caution flags.
Let's see, we had 20 laps of yellow before this caution for the guys that didn't pit, so.
And the rule of thumb is two caution flag laps make up one green flag lap. So we say 70 laps, green flag racing, well, you can run 140 under caution.
Yes, you can. That 48 car is a car to watch, though. He's been quick coming up through the pack. Each of these restarts, he knocks down one or two more and then gets a yellow to come back closer to the guy in front of him.
So was he restarted in first gear? If you're acting like it.
Yeah, you can. Definitely you need it with a Busch car. I've never driven one. But I would say you need first gear.
That's first.
Yes, it is. Good call, BP.
Pace cars off. Here we go. Matt Kenseth, Mike McLaughlin, Jimmy Johnson, Kevin Harvick, Jamie McMurray.
You ready? Green flag.
Good restart again for Kenseth.
Sure was.
Outside, Jimmy Johnson for second place on McLaughlin.
Definitely a bold move. He knows he's got to go. And at 25, they
USA has been struggling on power, so they took advantage of that. And here comes Harvick.
There.
That was so close.
Outside, inside, a little bit more of a nudge.
Man.
He just had to back off. He was way too close going into the corner.
So now it's Jimmy Johnson trying to track down Matt Kenseth for the race lead. Marty?
And on the radio, Matt said, I see him. Just leave me alone for a little while. Don't interrupt me on the radio.
Jones has got a big job to hold that 48 off.
SpongeBob is moving.
Tell you what.
Matt's driving for all he's worth, right?
He's on the wheel. That's right. When you see all those sparks flying, he's late in the race. He is on the wheel.
When you're out there racing and the guy in front of you bottoms out like that and throws all the sparks in the air, does it ever startle you, or are you used to it enough by now?
Used to it enough by now. Really, it doesn't affect you much. The smoke still, though, when somebody has a tire rub, you always think that there's oil, and so you check up just a little bit.
26 laps to go.
Kenseth was quicker that time, though.
Johnson trying to track him down, Matt.
Alan, Jimmy Johnson trying for his second Busch win, but he's also trying a little bit different engine package. 7 a.m. tomorrow, Howard Shipwash, the engine tuner for Kurt's brother Kyle, will be back at the shop, taking the valve covers off, taking a look at this engine. If all looks good, they are going to take the primary and backup engines out of the cars that are ready to go to Memphis, put this package in and run this package for the rest of the year, trying to win that Busch Series title and trying to win that car owner's championship for owner Rick Hendrick.
A little bit more horsepower, huh?
His best dream.
Kyle Busch trying to pick up another spot. This is 12th place he's working on Clint Bowyer for. Kyle in the 5.
Wow, Bowyer got a run on the outside.
Oh, Robbie Gordon's going to be in the way of the 33.
Oh, yes, he is.
Kyle. He makes it through there.
Caution's out.
That wasn't very nice of Bowyer. He did really good running through 3 and 4. Just was too busy racing the 5 instead of the 55.
That'd be what you call misjudging your closing rate. Huh?
Mm-hmm. Very good.
So this would be yellow number 11. And now we are closing in on the record.
The record is?
A dozen.
Yeah, we are. And we're probably not over yet.
Out, bumped into him. I've done that.
Just in a tough, you have?
Yeah, my buddy Biffle, my teammate during the All-Star race. I was trying to help him.
Oh, that's right. Down at one. That's
yeah.
Big wreck.
Yeah.
Big wreck. Yeah, I remember that now.
Robbie Gordon was 11th at the time.
Hmm. You know, the worst part of it, he never expected to get turned around at that spot, did he?
No, I was just coming off the corner. Mm-hmm. 33 had a tremendous run. Mistakes are made. How we all learn.
Oh, it doesn't take much, does it? I mean, it looked like he barely nicked him.
Yeah.
That's what we've got going on with these cars. The noses are pinned to the ground, the tails are up in the air, and that's one thing NASCAR is working on, is to lower the back of the Cup and Busch cars, even the trucks, so that the bumpers align, so that when you do have a circumstance such as this, it doesn't just lift the guy up in front of you. Because that's what does happen. The guy just gets lifted up.
Coming across, stay low, right in front of you, go high.
Uh-oh,
what's
Robbie's having a little trouble getting back around to pit road, I believe. Okay, this would be the, I'm trying to get back to pit road and it's not working out.
You got a flat tire, what's going on with the car? Something is amiss.
Something got twisted when he was spun around. Had to go through the grass, onto the asphalt, grass, asphalt. Looks like there's something wrong as far as locking up.
Looks like he just touched the brakes and the wheels lock up.
Yeah, see that?
What do you got, Rob?
Look at that.
Trying to pop him.
Front tire's just locking up. Matt?
AB, there is a tire rule here in the Busch Series. When you run out of tires,
yeah,
you might possibly try to get a flat.
Oh, I got you.
You think? So that way NASCAR will then say, yes, you do indeed have a damaged tire, and we will give you another tire.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's a safety concern. They spun around at 180 miles an hour. He's got flat spotted tires.
Well, didn't get any tires, so I guess Robbie got the word on that. Robbie will be reporting back to pit road at NASCAR's request. I have a follow-up on the why on that in just a minute. Meantime, the field's going to get the one-to-go signal when they come to the line, so we'll get a restart with 20 laps to go this time. Full speed.
Decisions, decisions when you're back behind that smoke. Go high, go low.
I tell you what, it's a good thing that car did not back up the racetrack into the outside retaining wall, because all those other cars, that's where they, the way they chose to go is out next to the outside wall. Hey, Matt, that 55 is coming back down pit road.
BP, they were asked to come back to pit road just to check his brakes, just to make sure that there was not any issue with his brakes on that 55 car. That's why he's making his way back down pit road. Marty?
Well, Matt Kenseth, not too excited to see this caution flag because his car was going really well, and he was actually a little bit faster than Jimmy Johnson, if not the same speed as him. Matt says it just takes about four laps for his car to come in. In fact, he said, Jimmy's probably going to pass me here, but we may be able to get him back if we have time.
Robbie Gordon has gone to the garage.
And really, truly, that was the wisest thing he could do. If he's not going to get any more tires, it would be unsafe out there on those tires, I really think.
Definitely. What we're going to see on this restart, Matt Kenseth might be alluding to, is that when you have so many yellows with the same set of tires on, what you have is tire sequence. You now have hot scuff runs on these tires. They get to cool off. So you have continuation of green run, yellow run, and your tires begin to change. All these heat cycles add to the tires, and sometimes they don't react the same way after a certain number of heat cycles. So Kenseth might be worried about the beginning of this run, but his car always is the one that runs on a good long run.
And I tell you a car that's very fast right now, Michael Waltrip. He's got that 99 car back up to the fifth position, and as usual, he's got that high line working beautifully.
Definitely. Wonder if he got his right front fixed.
He must have.
Waved off the restart, obviously, and given the one-to-go signal again, so we'll get a 19-lap race to the finish.
Looks like it's fixed to me.
Looks like it. A couple extra decals on there in his car. Patches.
All right, apparently Blake Feast and his crew chief and his spotter are being called to the big blue truck in the Busch Series garage after the race for discussion on how the lucky dog thing works.
Mm-hmm.
They were getting in the way on the lucky dog getting his lap back under this yellow. All right, Matt, go ahead.
Well, we've caught up with Robbie. Robbie, what's the situation?
Well, I guess Clint Boyer spins me, and they want to give me a penalty, so we'll park it.
Robbie obviously not very happy. So he is in the garage. The attrition list grows. That would make now 12 cars out of the race. And we're going to go racing with 19 laps to go. So does Jimmy Johnson get Kenseth on this restart like he did McLaughlin the last time, or can Matt hold him off?
Well,
won't be as easy as the 25 car, I'll tell you that.
Yeah, the difficulty factor, I think, is elevated just a little bit trying to pass the 17, because it's like he's pretty powerful. The engine's pretty good in the 17.
How about that?
How about that? We see Bliss and Michael Walker trying to go to the inside of the 99, and look at that 48 go.
48-17 for the lead.
Kenseth trying to stay with him. Johnson trying to power by on the outside.
Great racing.
What a terrific battle we got going. And here comes Bliss to make it three wide.
Woo! Oh, that's tight.
It is three wide for the lead. Who's going to back out?
Mike Bliss to the front with a three wide move off of turn four. How about that?
That was impressive.
Wow.
saw those two guys racing up ahead of him, and that just brings the 20 car right up to the front.
Man, oh man. Johnson trying to squeeze in front of Kenseth for second and see if he can set off in pursuit of Mike Bliss.
Here comes Kenseth back on the outside.
Makes it stick, gets that momentum run off of turn four, and will race down into one and two.
And Michael Waltrip, I think if he can get by these guys, he might be fast enough to chase down Bliss.
We know the 17's good on long runs, but he's hanging in there pretty tough. Here comes the 99 in the mix.
And this is what Mike Bliss wants to see. He wants to see these guys occupied racing each other.
Definitely. The 48 is just not shaking out like we thought he would. But he's on the inside lane, though, and that's what it's tough at Charlotte. You get pinched down. You get that guy on the outside that carries that momentum, and you get pinched down a little bit.
Waltrip still hanging outside of Johnson for third.
Barely lifted up in three and four.
Such a great racetrack. Side by side. This time by, Bliss is. Oh, no, Kenseth was quicker that time, so we might be able to reel him back in. These two are racing for third.
Oh, Johnson squeezed in front of him there.
Finally got him. But look at all of that distance, BP, that he lost from those leaders racing side by side.
To make up for Jimmy Johnson, and now two drivers to pass if he's going to win this race.
Oh, trouble up turn four.
Dave Blaney.
I think that Kyle got in the back of the 82 car up in three and four, Kurt.
Uh-oh.
Might have damage to that five car. And I may be wrong. I just looked up and I thought it was the five, but we'll see. Hopefully we'll have video to substantiate what I said.
Mm-hmm. So caution again with 14 laps to go, the last thing Mike Bliss wanted to see.
So this has really been a bad night for Armando Fitz and Terry Bradshaw.
Is that a third car?
Yes, yeah. It is.
That's not good.
That's too bad.
Well, this will definitely get a bit more interesting. We just keep adding up more and more things to see who's going to win this.
All right, let's go back and look at what happened.
All right, let's see. There's, yep.
Sure enough, Patrick swatted him.
Yeah, he did.
Looked like Dave kind of had to ease into that corner for some reason. And
that was the point of throttle, getting back to the throttle on time, and the 82 might have been a little loose.
Oh, Clint Boyer just barely gets by in that 33 car.
Let's listen. Throttles when he received a little help.
And from Kenny Wallace.
Coming in front of you. Go low.
On board with the Bobby Labonte.
And in front of you, hold your line. Down low. Straight through. Hustle. Coming across.
Mike Bliss's team.
No!
Oh, darn.
Darn! Kenseth right behind me.
Hardy.
Well, Steve Addington, are you shaking because you're nervous or because you're cold?
I don't really know right now, Martin. I'm going to tell you what. Mike Bliss drove his heart out tonight. We came in. We could have made it on fuel. We came in and made an adjustment here on this Rockwell Automation Chevrolet here. And we'll see what happens here. Those two guys are pretty strong behind us, but he's determined right now, so we'll see what happens.
He is driving like a determined man. We talked about that earlier today, didn't we?
Oh, he's growling on the radio. I don't know what that means, but he was ready to go right there.
Growling on the radio. Mike Bliss has never won a NASCAR Busch Series race. His best finish, third, four times. It could be the night tonight.
We
have seen some serious racing at the end of this.
I'm telling you.
All these yellows bunch up the pack, and we had different fuel playing out, but now it's all turned into racing. Hardcore, got your tires on, look for track position, and now it's time to take advantage of other people's mistakes.
On the last restart, Jimmie Johnson got alongside Matt Kenseth to race him for the lead, and what a breathtaking move Mike Bliss made off of turn four to go by both of them and get the top spot.
This is the restart. That's a power move.
Watch that 20 car go right on the inside of McLaughlin. Wow, good move.
While they kept racing side by side, they come around to turn four and get a little occupied with each other.
They're racing one another hard. And when you go into three, you have to check up just a little bit because you don't have the preferred line, either one of them. That's because they're racing side by side. Here comes Bliss with his full head of steam. Cuts underneath them and had just enough momentum to know that he could keep his foot in it. And the 48 wisely backed out.
What a great move on Bliss's part.
So let's see what happens on this restart, which will come with 11 laps to go. Bliss, Kenseth, Johnson, Michael Waltrip, Kevin Harvick, the top five. Followed by Biffle, McLaughlin, Truex, Kyle Busch, and Clint Bowyer. So Kyle has gotten all the way back now to where he's only one spot behind Truex. Unfortunately, as these races keep running out, the number left in the season, finishing one spot behind him or ahead of him isn't going to help him any.
Now they definitely need to pick up a bulk of points. Could have happened last week, but it didn't. Here's our restart.
25. Struggle on the restart again.
Chucky broke something. Something happened to the 25 car. And Michael Waltrip, the 99, did not get a good one. Dave, what happened to the 25, you know?
Mike reported in definitely a missed shift.
Oh, man.
That's not any good. We've got Biffle on the outside of Harvick now for position.
Fifth place there. Biffle able to hold him off. Actually, Biffle able to pick up the spot on Kevin Harvick. Front Bliss with a car length or two on Matt Kenseth. Jimmie Johnson not able to stay closed up on this restart. And now 10 laps to go.
10 laps is just the right amount of time for Kenseth, I believe. Bliss had a strong car. You put him out front, he'll go.
Kyle Busch, the 5 car, gets by McMurray in 66.
Put him up to 8th. Truex just ahead of him. Remember Kyle with the right front fender damage in the jam up on pit road with 64 laps to go and all the way back to 26th place and has rallied up through the traffic. 149 was the difference between the two starting the race. Like I said, even though the point damage will be minimal from that pit road incident, problem is now there's only going to be 5 races to go in the season after this.
There's Truex looking to hunt down Harvick. And last time by, it looked like Kenseth was just slightly slower. Too hard to even tell.
Yeah, I think he's going to be much faster this time. It looks like he has gained on Bliss. Let's see.
Definitely.
Just a little bit he gained, so making some progress, but he's running out of laps.
Got a little bit extra tape on the nose. A little piece of debris.
That's good.
It always helps.
I will say this, Kenseth is going to have to work hard to get around Mike Bliss because that is a determined young man.
It is. He is. And what I've seen, though, as of late with these cars, whether it's in the Cup Series and Busch Series, you get a car that's quicker in second place or whatever position it might be, and you catch somebody in front of you, you stick your nose right to the inside, right behind them, that front car does get loose. And it really takes a driver that is determined to stay out in front. So we'll see what Kenseth has.
Going to be right on the left rear,
and he's got some damage there on the left rear, so yes. Kenseth can get even closer if he wanted. These cars have gotten loose when you run them this hard, this close to one another.
Doesn't look like Jimmie Johnson's a factor for now, unless these two get side by side and Johnson can close up quickly. Less than 6 laps to go, 1 car length between them.
Just inching up towards him, isn't he, BP?
Yes, he's good. Oh! Blake Feces hit the wall up between 1 and 2. No caution yet.
Well, staying under green. 5 to go.
He's now in that zone of a little bit of aero tightness behind him. This is definitely
a race. Oh, man, that was close. That was close between 8 and 5.
just needs to back it down a little bit. He does have a quicker car, and he's not going to gain many points tonight running that hard. Uh-oh.
All right, Truex is going to let him go.
He got loose coming out of the two.
Truex is left rear tire is flat. No, maybe not. He was acting like down the backstretch he had a flat tire.
Four to go. Bliss looks like just tacked another car length onto his advantage over Matt Kenseth. He's hanging on.
He was a little bit quicker than Kenseth that last lap. Not much, but a little.
And by the way, Truex is up to speed, so everything's looking good on the 8 car.
I was wrong. He's sure testing that car out down the backstretch. Meanwhile, here comes Kenseth.
He's running a little different line than he has been the past couple laps.
Uh-oh. Off the pace, Dave.
Actually, I was going to tell you, between the 5 and the 8, they both pointed fingers at each other, and both crew chiefs told them to settle down and finish the race.
I'll check what's happened to Michael here in a second. Mike Bliss with 3 NASCAR Busch Series starts here at Lowe's Motor Speedway. He's finished in the top 5 in 2 of them, a 5th and a 3rd place.
Uh-oh.
Here comes Kenseth, getting that Kenseth high line going.
He waited. He didn't show his hand until 2 laps to go.
He is impressive. It's got to stick to 1 and 2 now.
Clear.
Looking low, trying to rattle him. Michael Waltrip, flat tire is his problem. That's why he's off the pace.
Just didn't get the run through 1 and 2 that he needed. We'll try again, 3 and 4. Kenseth's going to go up high. Get to build that momentum. Oh, that was a
man, he get a run off that corner.
White flag. 1 more lap. Steve Addington looking on to see if his driver can hang on and keep Matt Kenseth behind him. A hometown race before family and friends all looking on. Bliss trying to get his first NASCAR Busch Series win with the champion Kenseth behind him applying the pressure.
Bliss has done a phenomenal job. He got the lead and did not relinquish.
Corner for Mike Bliss. A 3rd to 1st move with 18 laps to go. It's going to pay off. Mike Bliss gets his first NASCAR Busch Series win.
Good show.
Passes 2 of the best in the business to do it. Kenseth and Johnson. And in his 70th try, Mike Bliss adds his name to the list of winners in NASCAR's Busch Series. Championship contenders finish in back-to-back positions. Kyle Busch in 5th, Martin Truex in 6th.
And they'll be talking to each other now when they get slowed down. How come you run into me? Why'd you run into me? Now, they're not going to congratulate the winner.
They're too busy staring at one another again.
Exactly.
They ran into the 20 on pit road, didn't they?
Yeah. No, Martin, I know what you want to do.
Don't do it.
It costs you points. We all know that these days. Don't do it. Don't do it. Don't do it.
That's not very sportsmanlike in the 8 car.
Stand
by. Mike Bliss. Fantastic job.
Well, here's a guy who doesn't know for sure where he's racing next year. Doesn't know if he's back in this car or not. Doesn't know if he's got another ride yet.
He shifted gear.
I think he's in 3rd gear. Oh, he's going to the corner.
He is, isn't he?
How about our mobile command performance? Nice burnout. And a commanding move to get the lead.
That was a great move.
Calculated risk. Once he knew he committed to that pass, he had enough momentum to clear. He made a great, great pass on this trip.
So Kyle obviously not happy. I'm sure Martin not happy. Everybody doing their thing to keep the situation calm.
Want to talk to his teammate for the race? Good effort on Hendrick's part.
Had to come back from 26th to 5th. Not bad for Kyle. Matty?
Well, Martin, describe what happened there between yourself and the 5.
I don't know. You seen it. I didn't. It don't matter. It was a good night. Had a good car all night long. It was tough. Track position was tough there at the end. But overall, I'd say it was a pretty good night for us.
And the message you were trying to send him there, following him really close down pit road?
No message. None at all. Just, I don't know what happened on the front stretch. I know I was under Harvick, and somehow he drove in my right rear or something. You know, I don't think I could have put him in a fence when I was already inside a car. So we'll look at it, see what happens. But great night. Real proud of the guys. Awesome stops all night, and just fought track position there at the end.
A very nice night tonight. Sixth place for Martin Truex, the point leader. Marty?
Matt Kenseth tried. You tried the high line twice to get around Mike West, but it just didn't quite work, did it?
Yeah, I didn't think we were going to get him. I just didn't have the power to get around him. So I'm proud of my Alka-Seltzer guys. We had a good car. Man, I hate losing. This was tough to lose all week. I've been thinking about trying to win this Busch race here or win the Cup race. I love racing at Charlotte. It was a good race, exciting race. I had a lot of fun with Jimmy, and Mike made a great move there to get by us three wide. And, you know, then I just couldn't get him. We were handling. I just didn't have the power. We just, you know, desperately need that new cylinder head for next year and, you know, got to get our motors tuned up a little bit. Our cars are pretty good. We just got to work our motors.
Well, it surprised you there, didn't he? Because you were racing with Johnson, and all of a sudden he shot to the inside.
Yeah, I didn't really know he was there, but we got slowed down. You know, I got loose under Jimmy, and you know, I was doing everything I could to beat him, and wasn't really worried about Mike. And he drove right in there. So he was the last thing I expected was to be three wide down the front start. So he did a great job, and you know, he deserves that win. He drove wheels off that thing, and I know he's looking for a job next year, and this will help him out.
Dave's in victory lane,
and Mike has just climbed out of the car to the cheers of his crew, and a big hug from members of Joe Gibbs Racing and his crew chief Steve Addington. And Mike, I know things are a little up in the air as far as what you're going to do next year. Have some more product on you. There you go. But this has to mean a ton to you as far as that goes and in your career overall.
You know, I love these guys. I don't want to go anywhere. I love these guys. I love Rockwell Automation. I mean, Dodge Reliance. These guys here all in the car, they don't get no recognition. Rockwell Software, Alan Bradley, Dodge, DVT. And I got to say a big congratulations to our good friend back home. They had a baby girl, and says it right there. And AG, this is for you, you know, for your baby girl.
On lap 181, you decided to go for the lead. There were two cars in the way. You made it three wide. Talk about that.
We worked on it all night, and I just I didn't care about second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth. I didn't care. I wanted to win this race at home. These guys deserve it. I wanted to win, and I just drove my heart out. And I do every weekend, but this meant a lot. And I just want to thank everybody at Rockwell Automation for giving me this chance. And they deserve more wins than just this one. And, you know, this is a different car than what we've run all year. And the guys back at the fab shop, you guys did a hell of a job on this car. And I hope that was the right word I could say. I apologize if it wasn't, but I'll pay the fine. But Mark Conquest for the motors, awesome motors. Just all these guys right here deserve this win.
Former Truck Series champion Mike Bliss in victory lane in the Busch Series for the very first time. Alan?
Sixth different first-time winner this season, and a pretty jubilant Reese's victory celebration for Mike Bliss.
That is truly a celebration that's going on in victory lane now.
Very deserving. To get that first one, it's always a big memory.
Here's how they ran tonight here in Charlotte. Bliss over Kenseth and Johnson. Greg Biffle from the back of the pack at the start of the race up to fourth. And Kyle Busch with the rally from 26th to 5th. Truex with a good points night in 6th.
Casey Mears finished 7th after having that tire problem.
Harvick. Lachlan goes back to 12th spot. Missing that shift on the restart.
All these guys on the lead lap back through 20th place. And Jimmy Spencer, last car on the lead lap. Michael Walsh wound up a lap down in 23rd after the late flat tire. A lot of guys failed to finish this one. 16 cars out of the race by the time the checkered flag waved.
A lot of crashes tonight at the Lowe's Motor Speedway.
And Wally.
Poor Wally.
Oil pump failure and did not finish. Joe Nemechek crashed racing for the lead early in the race with Casey Mears. And the championship standings now with 5 races to go.
Well, Kyle Busch does gain 5 points on Truex, but only 5 more races to go. Got to gain more than that.
NASCAR Busch Series in Memphis next Saturday. Tomorrow night, NBC, 7 o'clock Eastern Time. The NASCAR Nextel Cup Series from here at Lowe's Motor Speedway. We start with Discover Car Countdown to Green. Championship leader Kurt Busch going into that race. Thanks for being here with us tonight.
You got it. It's a whole new perspective sitting up top. Get to see good things, and hopefully they'll
translate into that tomorrow.
Wish you good luck tomorrow night. Next on TNT, Rocky III on the East Coast, Law & Order on the West Coast. First-time winner of the NASCAR Busch Series, Mike Bliss, tonight here at Lowe's Motor Speedway, Charlotte. We'll talk to you tomorrow.